All right, and we're back. Welcome back, everyone. It's been a week, huh? So, last time on ye old Dorkvision stream, what did we do? We left Kiever's Bale and then started a travel montage where the party got attacked by none other than a Spinosaurus, as well as several shadowy stags sent forth by Booncrash's patron, Rixali, and a near miss experience there, as her amulet got thrown into the swamps by none other than Mao, under possession, of course. He would never do that.
Sure, let's go with that.
Yeah. And then you guys had to find a new path across a flooded river and stumbled upon a owlbear den. The owlbears seemed corrupted by the same strange corruption that got that tree and turned it into a weird tree hydra. And just now you guys have found the path back to the road again, but you've also found some bodies with some invisible puncture wounds in them. Invisible arrow wounds, since Mao is strangely familiar with that exact type of ammunition. And that is where we come right now. Okay.
I think I'm more concerned is, was it me? And I didn't know. Because I've been possessed, apparently.
Aww.
So, you guys have elected to go after these... or investigate this strange happenstance. So I'm going to have you guys enter this sort of crowded thicket. The swamp has sort of overgrown this area with not only tall grasses, but like cattails and dead trees with like tons of Spanish moss kind of like hanging off of it. It's starting to get dark and misty as you go forward. I'm going to need you guys to make survival checks to try and keep track of where these corpses dragged themselves out from. It seems they were traveling for a bit while injured. Oh wow, that is oh, that's a stealth check.
I'm hiding. I was hiding from you the whole time.
Okay, let's see if we can get better than 12.
All right.
Working on it.
Well, it takes you guys a while, but eventually you start to become a little bit lost in the misty moors of Mullaghmoor. The trail goes soft as the floodwaters have returned, and you guys are kind of like up to your knees. But nonetheless, after about an hour of searching and getting turned around back upon yourselves, you enter a small muddy clearing, overgrown with small brush, and thick sloppy mud. However, there is a great, landmark in the center of this great clearing. It is what appears to be a short-walled, castle, complete with... like battlements all around this keep. However, as you get a little closer to it, you realize that this is in fact the second story of a castle. The rest of it has sunken far beneath the swamp. And what do you guys do with this information?
Don't move forward in case we sink.
I don't know, can I throw something? I want to throw a rock and see if it starts sinking. I don't know.
Sure.
Throw a giant rock.
I look for a decently sized rock.
All right, you lurk around and find a pretty hefty sized rock. You unstick it from the swamp and toss it out. Make an athletics check to see how far you get it.
I'll assist.
Sure. You guys both heft the rock.
You heave ho. Just...
Oh yeah, that's...
Heave-ho.
You heave-ho, and it slops right into the mud. Fairly close, like within, I'd say, about,
5, 10 feet?
20 feet of the castle. Cool. And it sinks a little bit, but it stops. Seems fairly stable.
Mm.
Okay.
I mean, it's better than...
I'm the heaviest one here. Should I, if I can, if I'm the one who can walk over it, we're probably all fine. So, here I hand you a rope. Just pull me up if I start sinking too much.
Tie it underneath your waist.
Alright, I'm gonna start
walking. If you're gonna sinking, why are we saying the heaviest one?
Because if I can, if we're trying to sneak, then if I'm the one
It's a stress test, I think.
Yeah. If I'm the one who makes it, then everybody else should be able to make it.
Alright.
He's just suicidal.
Are you guys taking your mounts, or are you, like, putting them off to the side?
Actually, if that's the case, of course you should go.
Gregory nods, begrudgingly. And starts trotting out into the...
Wait a minute.
Hold on. Okay, guys, we tie it to...
Guys, hold on a sec. I still have my nightmare, right? Or has it been a day?
It has been a few days, yeah.
Okay, so... Okay, never mind. I am here around. I just realized that we could just go through the ethereal plane, but guess not.
I mean, I can always summon Gregory if this don't work, like, afterwards. And I kind of give Gregory an old pat. I'll unsummon you if it gets hazy. So I'll tie the rope to him and I'll send him out first.
The horse trots out into the swamp, and they do start to sink a little bit. But before we have an Artax moment, it actually seems to have stopped. Yeah. Rope tied to a horse sinking into a swamp of hopelessness?
Jesus.
It could have been good. Chose not to, though. The warhorse seems to have stopped sinking. This castle seems to be fairly stable, now, at least. Probably sank over many years.
Okay.
Hmm.
But, as Gregory turns around to you, and, like, tries to, like, unstick their, hooves from the mud, turning back around, a strange blue haze, starts to rest over the battlements. And finally it coalesces into four spectral forms. They seem to be humanoid in shape, and they draw longbows.
I just swamp gas, don't worry about it.
And...
Don't look good.
We're gonna have to roll for some initiative, I think.
What? Swamp gas doesn't have arrows.
Several spectral arrows fly out towards you guys, some towards Gregory, others just kind of in your general direction, flying at you at random. You guys are considered surprised, but I will get the combat tracker going. I said I'll get the combat tracker going. Mm-hmm. What is going on here? Well, I think the API might be messed up, that's a little annoying.
You can roll.
Well, just roll for initiative, everybody.
Can we just roll now?
Yeah. I probably need to restart the API, because I reinstalled my browser. I don't know if that has anything to do with it.
Maybe.
Oh, shit, I forgot where the initiative that used to be on my...
It's, roll initiative at the top. Just of your macros. Yours isn't rolling? Do you have your character selected?
I was doing it from the character sheet.
Well, I'll do it for you anyway. Yep, it worked for
Did
you.
Did that work now? Okay.
Well, that was me doing
it. Oh, that was you? Okay, no, so then
yeah,
that was,
yeah.
I still can't do it.
Okay.
Okay, that's me.
That's you? Oh, okay, I will descending order again. Okay. So, Mao, you are surprised. Amon, you are surprised. Poor Gregory. This wraith starts to shoot the warhorse. Gregory's going to take 10 piercing damage and go down to 9 hit points. Tis this guy's turn. This one is also going to shoot at Gregory. And get a natural... Well... It's technically an 11, but I don't think that hits anyway. Oh, it just barely hits. Okay, Gregory pops.
I thought he had more AC than that.
No, he has 11, weirdly enough. The spectral, well, not spectral, but the magical steed disappears back into the ether. We continue on through the surprised rounds. This guy is going to shoot at... Mao. That is 10 piercing damage, Mao.
I'm gonna catch it.
Unfortunately, you cannot, as you are surprised.
Yeah.
And last one's turn. This one is going to fire at Amon.
It's not.
And misses. Okay.
Good.
Okay, top of the round. Mao, it is your turn.
I'm gonna look at Amon and be like, hey, do you think you can, do you have one of those things ready? You can, like, teleport someone up there?
Sure.
Cool. I'll hold my action.
Alright. To, do what? Attack?
Attack the nearest one.
Okay. Do you draw a weapon?
I draw my scimitar.
Okay. In that case, I can also tell you guys that it is about, 20 feet up, I'd say. Amon, it is your turn.
Alright, I gotta grab her by the head. Whoosh.
Where you guys want to teleport to?
Sure, over here.
Okay.
Here, you got scimitar, so put her right there.
Cool.
And then now I teleport to you, I assume you're gonna whack?
Yep.
Whack.
Help reaction.
Okay, that does hit. Just realized I don't have as much space because my thing wasn't maximized. Okay, that definitely hits, and that's gonna deal 9 slashing damage. Technically not a sneak attack, but
plus 1 for the necrotic, unless it does nothing to them because they're specters.
Yep. It does nothing to them, unfortunately. Come on. Slightly remembering how to play Roll 20. Okay. Anything else for you, Amon?
No, that's the extent of my, you know what, now that I'm in the middle of it, let me just use my, key point to, go into defensive stance.
Okay, take the dodge action?
Yeah.
Alright. It is this wraith's turn. This wraith, draws its longbow, and actually fires upon Boomcrash. And it is going to do a bonus action to increase its damage on this by attacking recklessly. And it misses. But that is good for you.
Yes.
Okay, yeah, it only has one attack. It is the Phantom Steed's turn.
Phantom Speed is gonna back the fuck up behind this tree and look for cover.
Okay, Phantom Steed tries to avoid popping. should I just remove them from the initiative?
Yeah.
Okay. Excuse me. It is the wraith next to Mao's turn. It is going to pull out its own short sword of a ghostly nature and strike at Mao. With a natural one. It misses. Ooh. Boom crash. It is your turn.
Woohoo! I'm going to aim at this dude and Eldritch Blast.
Alright. That does not hit. Because the creatures are behind battlements and they actually have plus 2 cover. So instead it blasts onto one of the crenellations. But you do have a second attack.
Yeah, gonna go for it again.
It also has advantage because... Okay, it has advantage because it attacked with its ability last turn. So that's gonna hit.
Oh, nice.
Deals 5 force damage. And knocks it back a ways. It sort of floats up into the air as it's blasted away, and then starts slowly teleporting, or, you know, drifting back to the ground. Anything else for you, Boomcrash?
I'm going to... Is there, like, anything that I can use for cover nearby?
There's the tree.
Yeah, I guess I'll hunker behind the tree.
Alright, sounds good. You duck behind the tree. Zumasu, it is your turn. Actually, do you want to have Goose do anything? I didn't roll for their initiative.
Oh, Goose. Yeah, I guess I'll have him fly up. But, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, hold on. What's his movement?
I think they take two moves if they need to.
Okay. So, one. I just want him hovering underneath these crenellations here.
Sure.
So he's not, like, directly in sight, but is still in proximity.
Available. Zumasu, it is your turn. What you up to?
Okay. I don't know. I don't know how I'm going to get 20 feet up over there.
I'm a paladin. I don't scale walls.
Oh, wait. What I could have done.
I'm going to see if I can find another entrance over to this thing.
Zumasu, if you want spider climb, you're gonna have to come towards me. Sorry.
You got a potion, or is it a spell?
It's a spell.
You can have Goose just fly and give it to me.
It's not a touch spell.
Oh.
I don't think.
Well, Zumasu, you can dash if you need to.
Yeah, well, that's 20 feet.
Oh, it is a touch spell!
Okay, so I'll just get in position over here and you can send Goose to touch me next
turn. Yeah, Goose.
Yeah, there you go. Goose.
There we go.
Is there anything I can use as cover by this battlement, or if I'm directly under it, does that help?
If you're directly under it, you look up and there's actually murder holes underneath the battlements. They would be able to shoot down at you if they had to.
Okay, so none of the. What about all of these things? Are they bushes or anything?
Those are bushes. You might be able to hide in there, but that would take an action for you.
If you want to be not shot, I recommend you go prone. It'll make you slow, but they'll have disadvantage on range attacks.
I'm gonna hide right here and go prone.
Okay, you drop prone. Right, it is, coincidentally, this dude's turn next. They are going to aid their ally and fire at a Mon. And they are going to use their bonus action to get bonus damage.
Disadvantage, though.
Disadvantage?
Because of the dodge. Stance. Dodge.
Oh, yes, because of the dodge. So that is gonna... Wait, does that still hit you with your AC?
No, I am 16.
Okay, cool. Then it is done. A narrow miss as an arrow, like a blue spectral arrow, whizzes past your head. And last but not least, it is... Yes, this one way over here. This one is going to... just sort of drift over here. Nyeh. And then fire at, we'll say Mao. Using its bonus action to increase its damage. That is probably going to hit Mao, unless you have a reaction that can negate this.
I can snare missile.
Okay, it is going to deal a bonus 8 damage, so that's 14 total that you need to deflect. Okay, so you deflect it by 3 as the arrow whizzes and kind of skids along your hand for a second, but you are able to grab it. The arrow disappears as soon as it hits your hand, though. So you only take 3 damage.
Yep.
Mao, it is your turn.
I'm going to attack the ones in front of me.
Okay.
Damn. No way to push them in or get, like... bonus action to like hide and shift or anything. Like,
yeah, there's not really any place to hide out here.
Yeah. Just attack.
That's gonna hit though. Okay, 8 slashing.
And then I'm gonna move to the other side.
Okay, you start dancing around the wraith, kind of ducking underneath its legs, which disappear as you pass through them.
Yeah, gross.
Right, anything else for you?
Nope.
Amon, it is your turn.
Alright, so... I guess I don't want to turn undead. Or do I? No, I really shouldn't. Okay, so I think I'm just going to take care of this thing by casting Toll the Dead.
You cast this, but they are unfortunately immune.
Right. Of course they are, because they're immune.
You still have a bonus action.
Yep. Alright. I think I'm gonna cast a spirit weapon onto. I can increase the strength of it to level 4. So it's 2 more dice. So it's going to be.
Are you able to drag it in? I'm just curious again.
No, I am not.
Okay. Then here you go.
Alright.
You able to move it?
No.
Dang it, what the heck?
Yeah, I gotta make my attack. Hopefully that hits.
That does. What type of damage are you dealing?
I believe it's... let me check.
You might be able to choose between... what type of damage it is. I tried re-giving you permissions, but I don't know if that'll help. Oh, actually.
Force damage.
Force damage, okay, that's good. Also, I know why it wasn't giving you permission. You should be able to move it now.
I am.
Excellent. I'll set that as the default token so we don't have to do that again. Cool. Okay, you summon your spiritual weapon, a red skeletal scythe with a black blade. It swipes through the thing, and it seems to hit it as if it's actually there. It shrieks in pain and takes... how much damage is that? 11 damage. It turns towards you in anger. Anything else for you?
Oh, actually 4 more damage. Sorry, because of the... spellcasting mobility modifier.
Okay.
That's it. Okay, I think I can move, so I think I'm just gonna get close. Just so that the Mao can have flanking. That's
right.
It.
It is this floating wraith's turn. It returns back to the crenellations, and then it takes aim at Mao. It has a flanking bonus here. And it's going to use its bonus action to increase the damage. Okay, that's probably going to hit you this time. You've had a turn, right? So you can do that. Okay. Okay, this time it is 15 damage. You reduce it by 10, so you take 5. Right, the one in front of you takes advantage of your sudden... diversion, and swipes at you with its short sword. This time, 22 for 7 slashing damage.
Ow.
Doesn't have the ability to boost this attack. Booncrash, it is your turn.
Okie dokie. I called a goose and try to send him over to Zuzu.
Okay, Goose is going to move as fast as Goose can, and that is 50 feet. Okay.
Oh, shit, that's a lot longer. That's a lot further than I thought he could go.
So you can go here, and then you can go here.
Yep. So, okay, thank you.
If Zimasu can get to Goose, then you can definitely get this to happen, because I think it takes the familiar's reaction, so it can do it out of turn.
Okay, fabulous.
So I just high-five the bird and I can climb.
Essentially, yes.
Yeah, so I'm going to telepathically communicate to you, Zuzu, what the heck to do, and I'm going to ready my action to cast Spider Climb on Zuzu.
Okay.
Cool.
You text Zuzu, look at the birdie.
get the birdie!
Zimasu, it is your turn.
Okay, that's what I'm going to do.
Get over here, you little rascal.
Ba-doom.
Okay.
High five the bird.
Spider
and,
Climb.
Yes, I'll spider climb the rest of my action to go up the battlements.
Alright, cool. Remember you had to use half your movement to get up from prone.
Okay, so... that's
so that was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I think you have 15, or if you dash you have 30 left.
Yeah, I'm gonna dash, I think all that brings me to is to the top of the battlements.
Yep, I said it's 20 feet high, so it's probably just maybe an extra 5 feet to climb over the top there, so I'm gonna say you can get there.
Okay. So am I on the top, or am I just hanging off?
You can be on the top or just hanging off, whichever you want.
I'd rather be over here.
On solid ground?
I don't want to be shot at while I'm hanging. Yeah.
That's fine. Yeah. You climb up and leap over the battlements right near this other archer of sorts. I'm also going to have you make a history check right now while I take their next turns. Unless you have a bonus action you want to use.
I'm going to cast shield on Mao.
Okay, sounds good. Mao, you have a shield of faith that is got Hieronius' symbol on it and whatnot.
What's the pluses?
Two.
Plus two. Okay. It's just floating around you. Okay, this one draws its short sword as it senses you nearby, and it spins around to attack. Ooh, that's going to be five slashing. Minimum damage, but still a very solid hit.
What is the history do at 17?
You recognize their armor. It's old leaf crown armor.
Oh, this ain't good.
Okay, next Wraith's turn. It is...
Only if you take your uniform.
This one's turn. It is going to strike at Mao. It once again has a flanking bonus of plus one. That's going to hit. You're going to use... I don't think you have your reaction anymore.
Nope.
But it's going to deal a bonus... Three. So you take 12 damage. And Mao, it is once again your turn.
Oh.
I'm going to yell out to everybody. I think these guys are wearing leaf crown armor.
Yeah, well, they're still hitting us. Kill them. I'm going to attack the nearest one.
Okay. You spin around and strike, but it is not quite enough. Even with a flanking bonus, it's still shy.
Shit. I might just bonus action disengage.
Okay. Where to, man?
Hide around this battlement over here.
Okay, just make sure you have the movement for it.
I do.
Okay. You tumble right through the thing's legs again, scrubbing off the little wisps, and then tumble behind the crenellations on the other side, just around it. Below, you can see that the mud of the swamp is overtaking this keep. It's sort of sunk in at a diagonal. Amon, it's your turn.
Alright, first of all, I'm going to do the bonus action to attack with a spear weapon, just to see if it gets rid of this.
Okay. That's going to hit.
Okay.
Let's get some intense rolls.
Take the first one, obviously, plus a four, so that's going to be 17 damage.
That is intense. The scythe slices right through its waist, and it disappears in a flash of light.
Alright, I'm going to go up here. And I'm going to the Channel Divinity for the first time in a long time, and turn undead. Wisdom saves, please.
Okay. Is that gonna reach this dude over here? Just making sure.
No, it's only 30 feet.
Okay.
I strictly made it so that I'm not gonna touch that guy because you guys are attacking that thing.
That's true too. Okay, the highest was a 15.
Alright, so they should fail it. And so that the turn for 1 minute or 10 rounds. It can't willingly move to a space within 30 feet of me and can't take any reactions. And for its action, it can only use dash action to escape.
Okay. Their hit dice is 6, if that matters. I don't think it does.
No, they don't. I don't instantly destroy them like that.
Okay, you
half or something.
What sort of holy symbol are you presenting?
The only one I have in Kavalos is
your shield. You present your holy symbol. A strange manifestation takes place. A bloody red skull emerges from this shield, and just sort of does like a kooky Halloween noise, and then frightens out these creatures. It's something that you haven't seen before, but these wraiths are terrified by it and begin to just sort of hover a foot off the ground and begin to retreat. Okay, anything else for your turn?
This is all my actions and such.
Turn on did work?
Yeah, it did. Okay, it's this guy's turn. It is going to sort of float over the side and just move away. It drifts slowly towards the ground. Well, it moves as fast as it can, I think. So it's just gonna dash all the way to this corner here.
Alright, we're doing yakety sacks now. Someone turn the music. I can chase these ghosts.
Okay, Boomcrash, it is your turn. It looks like the one near Amon is also frightened. If you hit it, it might no longer be.
Okay, I won't fuck with that then. I send Goose up to the battlements.
Right, Goose flies up after Zimosu.
Okay, can he perch on that ghost and do a shocking grasp?
We'll certainly try. Make a spell attack.
Oh, not good.
Yeah, that doesn't hit. You seize control of Goose and launch their talons towards the creature, but it passes right through it off onto the other side.
Whoops. Sorry, buddy.
Okay, anything else for you?
I guess I'm gonna step out and see if I can draw any fire.
Okay. And Zimosu, it is your turn.
I'm gonna do a perception check to see if these things communicate. So I'm just gonna talk to them and see if they do any sort of response, like listen to what I'm saying.
Yeah, you don't need a check for that, you can just try.
Alright, I'm just gonna call to them and say like, hey, and I'm gonna recite like a leaf crown oath or some sort of thing that they know about, I guess. I don't know, whatever, like I assume there's probably some sort of basic like pledge or something they had to take. So I'll just say that to them.
Glory to the Leaf Crown! Glory to the Aloran Senate! You shout, as the ghost seems strangely perplexed. Make a persuasion check.
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting. I might want to roll against that. Okay. As you say this, the Leaf Crown ghost sort of stops with its sword play, and then as it looks you up and down, its eyes turn a fiery red once more, brighter than before. You betrayer! And then it tries to stab at you using its reaction.
Oh boy.
Uh-huh.
It misses.
Alright, I'm gonna drop the shield on Mao and I'm gonna go detect thoughts on it.
Okay. You attempt to read its thoughts, but it is nothing but a cacophony of, like, screams and whispers. It seems that the spell doesn't seem to work on undead.
Okay. I'll just get between it and Mal, then.
Alright, you backpedal around it, holding up your longsword, threatening the creature.
Who? Did the Leaf Crown betray you?
It just hisses at you. I'm gonna have to end your turn. It's actually its turn, so it's going to reply with a missed short sword attack as it continues to madly swipe at you, its feet are like lifting off the ground as it does. I die! And it's this one's turn over near Amon. It is going to run away, because that is what it does. This one is going to run. It's going to just start drifting to the ground off this way, running off into the swamp. Okay, Mao, it is your turn.
I'm gonna drop the scimitar and pull out my cinder smite.
Okay.
Bonus action hide before shooting?
Against which one?
Against the one that Zamasu's attacking?
There's not really any place to hide, unfortunately.
Okay, I'll just shoot it. I'll move so that way at least Zimosu's not in the way.
Okay. I mean, you have your sneak attack because Zimosu is next to it.
True.
That's gonna hit.
Wow.
Okay, that is 20 damage for the initial attack. And then 22 for the sneak attack damage. Yeah. As you tumble out from behind Zumasu, who is currently enraging the creature, Cindersmite lands a vicious blow that kind of explodes its internal, whatever ghostly structure it has before the spectral or fiery arrow bursts out its back. It howls in pain and anguish. Anything else for you?
Nope. Just you, Plasma.
Is it dead or is it...
Well, nope, is it is...
Is it gone?
It is just hanging on. Amon, it is your turn.
Alright. First of all, I'm going to move the spear weapon a little bit. The bonus action.
Whee!
And I'm going to use my action to dash. So... Get back here. Okay, that's it.
Run away! No, not like that!
Well, actually, hold on. I just realized that I got the new level in Monk, so I'm actually faster.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
You're now horrifying.
Okay, let me just see unarmed movement.
We need to get on
increase
the
10 feet. Okay, so I get to move 4 squares more.
In order to show off his Monk skills, he made the undead run fast so that he could run faster.
Alright, thank you. Now the Scouting Wraith is inside my 30 feet range, so it's got to run again.
Okay, cool. You start running down the slope, sinking into the mud. The ghost is, of course, still afraid of you. They don't get any extra saves, right? I didn't really think about that.
Oh, no, nothing like that.
Okay, cool. I think it is that guy's turn. It is going to flee. Continues to do so, and it is like right at the edge of the map. Booncrash, it is your turn.
Okie dokie. I'm gonna pop out and Ultra Blast this dude because he's nearby.
Okay, pop out from behind the tree at the fleeing wraith and launch a shadowy Eldritch Blast towards the creature.
And that doesn't hit.
Oh, I'm not seeing it yet.
Does a 21 hit?
Yeah, it does.
I rolled a 15 and a 21.
Yep, I mean, 21 does hit. Okay, now it's all starting to pile on top of each other.
Sorry.
It's not your fault, it's probably because I have a stupid browser virus. Still need to take care of that. Okay, it takes 10 damage and is pushed 10 feet away. The 15. The 15 doesn't hit, sorry. I thought it was on the same thing. Okay. Then, Zumasu, it is your turn.
I'm gonna try and reason with this thing again. Look, you're on your last leg. Do you want any help or not?
It is completely maddened. It is not listening to reason.
Okay.
What are you doing, Zumasu? Just kill it!
It's already dead!
Man, that missed.
It did miss.
Is that it?
That one does, yeah. Roll for that.
I can't do non-lethal
damage
against a ghost if it's a magical weapon, can I?
It doesn't seem so. It would be difficult for you to do that.
How do you knock out a ghost?
You try to whack it upside the head with the hilt of your sword, but it goes straight through its skull, which shatters into 1,000 ghost pieces. Ghost blood goes everywhere, and then the ghost disappears.
Most violent ghost death ever.
Just go stop that, bonk, and then its head explodes. Oh. Okay.
That's two attacks.
That was the D8 with the radiant damage.
Was the 9 a longsword attack?
Oh, yeah. And no,
yes.
Only one of my attacks hit. Yeah.
So, any other actions?
I used an attack, so, I don't know.
Movement?
Wow, you want any heals? Let's start going towards him. Just come over to me and I can give you heals.
Okay.
That's it.
Which one is that? That is that one's turn. This one has gotten damaged now. It floods with a reddish hue as it starts to rage. And it's going to run... Well, actually, it doesn't need to run. It's just going to move back a little this way and fire at Booncrash using its longbow.
These are weird swamp gases.
I know, very deadly, weirdly.
Swamp gas talk.
It's going to be 8 piercing damage, and it's going to increase the damage by...
Entropic 7. Ward, it doesn't hit.
Oh, okay. Well, it is a vicious blow going straight for like your gut, but you cause a shadowy portal to appear. It goes right outside of your back.
Nice.
Okay.
Mao, it is your turn.
I'm going to move up to Zamosu. I wasn't sure if you had like a bonus action or something you'd save.
I can't bonus action at the moment, unfortunately. You can still go for it. I just figured I'd be moving directly your gun.
To move around you after realizing you're not healing me now, I'm going to shoot at the wraith down on the ground.
Smalls is like, let me heal you, and then he holds up his hand, and you go, just a minute, and run around the side of him, and fire Cinder Smite towards the wraith. That is going to definitely hit. It's not a sneak attack, unfortunately.
I have advantage if I'm above.
They didn't really have advantage against you, so I'm not going to give it to you. I probably should have, but fair is fair. Okay, it's going to take 17 damage. Anything else?
Bonus action, high.
Okay, you duck behind the crenellations. That I will allow. Amon, it is your turn.
Amon, right. Tell him about, what's the name of the... Atorus. Mention Atorus's name.
I can't hear you.
Damn it.
I choose not to.
God damn it, it's just for the rage. I'm gonna shake my fist at it. and then, okay, I think I'm gonna just, okay, fine, I will mention, Atorus' name. Damn you, Atorus! Okay, that's it.
It doesn't seem to care.
Okay.
It is still fleeing.
I figured he might be old enough.
Alright, it is this dude's turn. It continues to run for another 60 feet south before it finally disappears, turning into mist. It has left the battlefield. Booncrash, it is your turn.
Okay, Eldritch Blast.
Kurzawi. Aha, it worked.
21.
You hit.
Yay!
Deal 14 damage as it is blasted away. It is not looking too hot.
Neat.
Okay, another hit. This will probably do it in.
Cool.
It does just so. Your final shadowy blasts collide with it and discorporate its form just enough that it can no longer keep it together. It shrieks and in a blast of light, it disappears.
I did it! It's been a while since I've killed something.
Just waving from like the tower. Cool.
Hi,
hey guys.
Everybody.
By the way, how do I get up there? Are there like stairs?
Not really. I can throw you a rope or something.
That'll be great. I just want to like save slots just in case.
Amon is on the other side. It's actually sloped. It sinks into the mud on the back.
So if she goes to the other side, she'll be able to climb up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Easy enough, and I can just say you did that. Although, when you
are
explore...
Are we still in combat or no?
Nope. The other creature that escaped, it doesn't seem to have returned. It's probably too frightened to do so.
I'm going to heal Mao for 20, and then also use a cure wound.
Okay.
So, cool. She gets 10 plus 20, so 30.
While you guys are doing that, I'm gonna go head down to downstairs to look at see if there's anything of interest down here.
I'll keep an eye on you from above.
You descend.
I wanna come too.
You descend onto what appears to be the roof of the castle. There's like a wooden sort of walkway between some stony structures. It's overgrown with moss and trampled with mud. Now that these strange blue wraiths have gone, there is a strange, like, other mist rolling in, this sort of pine-green mist. Tiny pinpricks of light are starting to rise from the castle and just flit around harmlessly. Probably.
Is this like the green we saw with the other creatures, or is this different?
Make a arcana check.
Oh, I'm good with those. Not.
Ah, good. An arcana check. Judging by your vague understanding, different color might be different.
No, okay.
You're not really sure what it is, though.
Do I remember... Okay, can I do, like, a history check to see if I remember anything about a possible fort here or something?
Sure. Can certainly do that. I don't think anybody else would really have this knowledge.
I was only guessing since maybe I saw something in, like, an old paper or some shit.
I'm gonna say you don't have any direct knowledge. I'm gonna say that Mullaghmoor used to be a greater part of the Aloran Kingdom.
Okay, so it's just, I just know that it wouldn't be far-fetched for something to possibly be here.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Let's see if we can get in, guys. It bothers me that leaf crown ghosts are chilling.
There does appear to be a door underneath of the crenellations there that leads into the building.
Guys, wanna go dungeon crawling?
It's better than being out here. What about our mounts?
You can just resummon them.
You mean the mount?
Mine has to be resummoned.
They're magic.
Anyway.
So, five Raven Stack.
Okay, you guys creak open this door. It is sort of kind of stuck with mud, but a few tries gets it open lickety split. Just want to make sure that everything is all set.
Ostrich not with us, but they're here with us in spirit. All the mud.
Okay.
And Ostrich let himself go if he's all the mud.
I have become the land.
Ostrich has become a god. That's pretty intense.
God of mud. And what are you the god of?
Filth.
Alright, so what are we seeing as we walk through?
Okay. I see greens of green.
Yeah, these strange things are more frequent in lighting up the room in dim light. You head down into a sort of entrance chamber, weirdly enough, on presumably the second story of this structure. Around the room are arranged... six statues. Each one appears to show an elven, like, leaf crown guard standing upon a sort of geometrically patterned stone plinth. And there's six of them. They're each facing in, like, different directions, but they are all in the same pose. They are just standing upright at attention.
Is there this actual glowing greenness too?
That is generally moving around. They aren't standing still. It's environmental.
Oh, okay.
There's a strange feeling that sends sort of shivers down your spines as you enter this area.
I'm gonna do a religion check. Boomcrash, can you sense any magical stuff here?
Okay. I'll cast detect magic.
Okay. You begin to cast it as a ritual spell, I assume, and take a few minutes to do that. Otherwise, do you guys do anything in this meantime?
I'm gonna close the door behind me.
Okay.
Going in?
Yeah. The door kind of traveled up another flight of stairs to the right before hitting the door to the outside. So you guys kind of like took a turn as you came down. Okay, if anybody else isn't doing anything, then Boomcrash finishes their spell.
None of the elves are, like, distinct or noticeable, right?
You don't know. They're all kind of facing different directions, so you can't really tell from here. But they all look relatively identical. You'd have to probably inspect them further. Boomcrash, you do detect a general sense of necromantic magic emanating pretty much everywhere in a 30-foot radius of you. It's kind of interfering with stuff a bit, but that is the only type of magic that you can sense nearby.
I convey this to the rest of the party. General spooky but nothing specific here.
So... Do you need me to channel undead again? I mean, the channel.
What was that?
Turn undead again.
I mean, maybe
save
be prepared.
It for when they appear. All right. I guess we should investigate these statues, see the room. I'm gonna do a general investigation to see the differences between the statues. See if anything's distinct.
Okay. That's gonna be an investigation check. Okay, that's pretty good. You start looking around, and they all seem to be identical. They were carved to look the same. They're definitely made out of, like, Aloran marble. Though there is something unusual about the statues. Each of their stone plinths is not Aloran marble. It is like a sort of limestone sort of texture. And furthermore, the carvings seem less precise, per se, than the elven statues.
So what they're standing on is kind of rough and different?
Yeah, it looks very different and a lot older. They're covered in, like, these geometric patterns that sort of do spirals and zigzags around it. You also see various animal imagery as well. It almost looks like an ancient, like, Mesoamerican sort of style.
Oh no, it's the Shrine of Tomoachan.
Oh god. Hey, this reminds me of when we met you guys.
Uh-huh.
I have no recollection of this series of events.
You would have had to breathe poison.
It wasn't fun.
You didn't miss much, Amon. Be grateful.
There was a vampire. Is this a door or something over here?
There is a door to the north. This door seems to be wrought iron and made of wood, although the wood is starting to, like, rot away a bit in the center.
And is that the only other door other than the stairs? Or
It's hard to see because of the wall pattern, but there are a set of double doors to the south. These are made of stone.
Okay. Can I see if these statues are movable? I want to literally lift them up and see if what's underneath them.
I'm just going to lift up this 5-foot diameter plinth and statue.
Knock over
real
the statue.
Quick.
I mean, if I have help, maybe, but how heavy is it and all that jazz?
I'm going to have you make an athletics check.
Okay. Mal, can you help me?
Not even that strong.
You just need to help me brace it.
I try and topple it over.
Okay.
You guys start pushing from, like, opposite ends as Zumasu's, like, kind of pulling and Mao's kind of, like, pushing. You get a 16 end up with, and the statue doesn't move, but it does seem to rotate slightly from your opposite movements.
Oh.
All right.
Okay, so these things can turn. If this is one of those type of puzzles, then I don't even know where they gotta turn.
I don't know, just make them all face each other.
I mean, I guess we could do that? Okay, we'll spend a few minutes doing that, because now they're... How are they all facing for now?
I'm gonna say that they are facing pretty much random directions. I see what you're doing, though. You turn them all, and they do all end up being able to move on these sort of Mesoamerican plinths. You twist them clockwise and counterclockwise until they are all facing each other. As soon as the last one turns to face, you hear a click in the southern doorway.
That was the metal worn-out one? That's the double doors.
Yeah, the double doors in the south. They have, like, these Aloran tree patterns covering them. But as the last one falls into place, I said a click, but it's more like a...
Alright, do we want to go through this door or the door in the back?
I'm going to check both of them to see if they're trapped.
Okay, let's check the back door first. I'll be behind you.
I'm assuming we're only going to be able to go so far. If this building is under mud, we don't know where it's been covered inside.
We'll see.
You open up this door. There's a sort of rush of dust and mustiness from this room.
Am I immune to dust?
I mean, not really. Nobody is, really. You look
just
inside.
Poison, but not dust.
You look inside of this room, and it appears to be filled with sets of, like, rusty armor and rusted over blades and spears. Definitely of elven make, but excuse me, even after this much time in Mullaghmoor, they seem to have started to decay.
I mean,
wait, is there any... The armor's expensive, yo. Is there anything I can shove in my bag of holding?
Anything remotely salvageable? Or is it just a pile of rust?
Yeah.
So, wait, so these... The race that we saw, they were... Like...
They were elves, right?
The Leaf Crown Guards, they seemed to be. Or at least they had elven facial features. Perhaps half-elven.
But they're also the... Why did that one yell at you? Why did it say that you were a traitor or whatever?
I couldn't really tell if it was just angry because I said it was from Alora, or if it was angry because I didn't look like an elf. I couldn't tell.
Leaf crown, maybe?
Well, I'm not wearing leaf crown stuff, so maybe it knew about that part too. So I'm not really sure. Can I do like a reverse insight check on that?
I'm going to say no. You just have to interpret it as you will.
Okay, so it could be a number of things. It either could have a thing against Alora, it could have a thing against the Leaf Crown, it could have a thing against, you know, Yonti. I don't know. I look like a human right now, don't I? My disguise?
I assume while you're traveling, you kind of didn't need to keep up your disguise very much, but you could pass for one fairly easily.
Put on some Leaf Crown armor. Maybe it'll be like, fine, I'll put on some Leaf Crown armor.
Is there any plate armor here, or enough to at least make it look like we're Leaf Crown?
Make an investigation check. Or perception check.
Okay.
Okay. It looks like there isn't much here to salvage. They are all pretty rusted up.
Alright, never mind then.
Are there any spears that are good? I'm just going to shove a few spears in my bag.
You go towards the spear rack in the back to start grabbing a few and, like, putting them in your backpack. Mao heads over to Amon and Boomcrash, who are inspecting the door. Zumasu, as you reach out to touch one of the spears, suddenly you hear a clatter of metal behind you. Several of these swords resting on the armor rack have started to rise forth, and then they launch themselves at you. Here we go.
Oh, great. Animated swords.
One of them swings at you with a longsword attack. With the surprise attack, it's going to deal 4 slashing damage. It's time to roll for initiative again, boys.
Did we even hear?
You guys have heard this thing happen.
Yeah, you probably heard just a big clank as it hits me, and I'm like, damn it!
Yeah, you parry the other ones, and, like, the shield batters off the second one, but combat begins to ensue as these swords start flying around.
I tried to grab some spare spears, and these swords didn't like it.
Some spares.
I'm impressed that I didn't grab the shiny that got us in trouble. Like, this is a change of pace. This is good.
They're a little dull.
Development.
Rusty. It's not even shiny. It's mad rusty. Yeah. I just wanted a stick.
Okay. One of them is going to surround you at the start of the turn and swing. It misses. Amon, you hear this funny stuff happening from behind you.
Alright, you know what? I think I'm just going to go up here and heal Mal for a bit. Like, I'm not in a big hurry. Let's heal you for... Okay, cure wounds, so 1, 2, 3, okay, so 3d8, plus 4, so 16 for you.
Man, this is awesome having healers on the team.
And I'm gonna go up here and roll my eyes a little. Okay. Alright, let's, everyone else, do your thing.
Okay.
What if we just close the door behind them?
Yeah, that's what I was saying, but I'm going like last.
Okay. Boomcrash, it is your turn.
Okay. Jesus. I'm gonna
Give me a second.
Come closer and try and... I'm going to try and blast that one.
Okay, you reach in from the other room. They sort of have cover because of all the stuff in the way, but...
Jesus.
Oh, that's going to miss.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to try again. Eh?
Okay, that is going to hit, and it's going to blast this one clattering into the spear rack. Takes 12 force damage. It is very damaged. The tip of it is like shattered off, but it is still standing. Well,
oh, yeah.
Floating.
Was I able to at least grab a spear before all this went down?
Yeah, pretty much. That's what seemed to have triggered this thing.
Okay. So I'm putting the spears in my back then. I'm at least taking my damn spoils.
Sure. The swords start attacking you, and you start shoving the spears into your bag.
Don't put ghosts in your bag.
Okay, it's this sword's turn. It flies towards Zumasu to attack.
What?
15 doesn't hit. 16 doesn't either. Okay. The one on the other side continues its assault. And that's not gonna hit. Mao, it is your turn.
Can you just prep an action to close the door once I get out?
Sure, I'll stay on this side of the door then. Ready to close it.
Okay.
After he leaves.
Zumasu, you shout, "I'm coming out! Close the door behind me!" Meanwhile, this sword...
Bonus action hide.
It notices you guys gathering in the doorway, and it tries to fly at Mao.
Ooh. Actually, where am I on the initiative list?
Did you roll for initiative?
Oh, I thought you did. No.
Nope, I can't do that.
I thought it was light. I guess I am going last then, just by that nature.
Okay.
Can you just plug me in there as a one or something?
You still gotta roll it.
I did it for him.
Okay.
And he got a one, actually, weirdly.
Okay.
Oh no, he didn't. I just rolled twice, I see. Okay, so that one is going to deal 3 slashing damage to Mao with a very weak critical hit. Next one's turn. That is Amon's turn?
I think you put me on the bottom.
Oh,
but
you reset the initiative.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I tried to reset it so that it would do it properly. Let's try and go down. Mao just went, that one just went. So it is Zumasu's turn.
Yeah.
I'm also gonna
get out of here.
I'm also going to enter the app again because I'm having a weird
just a
error.
Cage action. Hey guys, now close the door.
I'm ready in action to close the door.
Okay, it passes through. Zumasu passes through, and you try to slam the door. I'm going to have you make a sleight of hand check posed by this thing's attack roll.
Oh, I see what's going on. Ting.
How is it gonna break the door, ain't it?
Damn it!
I actually can't see what you... Okay, it just barely gets one swing at you, Mao, as it soars through the doorway. And it is going to deal 3 slashing damage.
At least they don't hurt that much.
But you slam the door on the rest of them, and then you hear... 2 thunks on the other side as 2 blades sink halfway through the rotted away doorway and start struggling. Okay. It's this pro sword's turn. It is going to continue attacking Zumasu.
Stop that.
Does a 20 hit you? I don't think it does.
No.
Okay, it misses.
Stop that, Mr. Sword.
I'm on. It is your turn.
Alright. In that case, we can try to close the door again, right?
No, the door is closed. One of them just slipped through.
Okay. You know what? In that case, against better judgment, I'm going to punch the sword.
What? Okay.
Kia!
I love your character. And I love that claim. That's just great.
You punch the sword successfully.
All right.
Nice.
Yeah.
You deal 4 fist damage.
come the double 20s.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna spend my flurry of blows, so I can just punch twice. Basically.
Ooh, that's a miss, unfortunately. Even with the flanking bonus, that's still one away. Still one away. Okay, your flurry of blows seems to be exhausted. The one lucky hit sent it spinning off into the air, and your other blows couldn't connect. Okay, the sword continues to struggle against the door. Boom crash, it is your turn.
Okie dokie. Oh wait, is that a fucking sword right in front of me? Great.
Yeah, it is. There is a statue also in the way, kind of.
Great. Okay. Goose.
Get in. Yeah, what do you want, babe?
Okay. Get in the sword and shocking grasp.
Okay. It's made of metal, so I think it has disadvantage. Or, I think. You have advantage? Is that how that works?
I don't know.
I think you have advantage. That's going to hit.
What's it again?
For a metal target of a shocking grasp spell.
Let me check.
Either way, I'm pretty sure that's going to hit. Roll for that shocking grasp damage.
Yeah, advantage on metal.
Target is wearing metal or made from metal.
So, okay. So
I think it's
grasp.
3d6.
That's pretty good.
Okay.
Oh, it's 3d8.
It should be d8. Shocking grasp is like a d8 spell.
Yep. Right, that is 13 damage. You reach out towards the bladed weapon and shock it. The rust seems to like clatter off of it in like flakes, and there's like a weird metallic ozone scent in the air. But the sword cripples under the weight of this sudden shock, and it is destroyed.
Yay,
you hear two thunks on the other side of the door as the swords fall out.
Go Goose!
All right.
Good job, guys. I got a spear.
Yay.
Let's not touch things unless they look like they're valuable. Looks like a stick.
Yeah, pretty much. I don't know. Sometimes sticks are useful.
Uh-huh. I'm gonna check the door for traps on the side just before we go through.
Okay.
Okay. Make an investigate. Okay, you investigate the door for traps. It doesn't seem to have any, it just has a mechanism, but you recognize that as the strange puzzle.
The traps from before. Alright, I'm gonna slowly creak open the door. I'm like, alright, we all ready?
Yeah.
Don't touch more sticks.
Okay. Start to creak open the door. The heavy stone skids towards you, weirdly. As you step inside, you see a door on the other side. Although it kind of looks like it's closed there, it has actually been burst open, and there is just a overflow of mud and muck that has spilled into the room. It's difficult terrain.
This would be like the first floor, right?
This seems to be a lower floor.
Okay. I'm gonna come in with Mao.
Or sorry, not a lower floor. It's the floor right under the roof.
Yeah.
Oh.
Is that a door or something?
No, it is not, but I think you passed through it. I'll just reset the fog. There we go.
Okay, was that a window?
No, it's a solid stone wall. Zumalsu, stop going through it, please.
It's just the wall. It's just the wall in place.
I found the speedrunner's clipping point.
Well, wave past everyone, if whoever's following, just point out the things I see. And I'm moving quietly.
I'm gonna send Goose with you.
Alright. I'll stay like 10-15 feet back from now.
Okay. I've turned on restrict movement, so that shouldn't happen again. I usually have it on, but I for some reason didn't in this room.
This doesn't look good. I do not like the look of this room.
You head into this room and there are more of these strange little pinpricks of pine green light that are floating about the room. There are several skeletal remains here. Some are wearing armor, some are wearing clothes that have long since started to decay.
Can't speak with undead. I don't know.
Do you know anybody that can?
Mr. Amon, can you speak with undead?
Let me see if I actually have it prepared.
Can I just do a medicine check on these to see how they died? If it was just
sure, you can do that.
Something else. Like it wasn't like they were murdered.
No, I did not have it prepared. Sorry about that.
Plot, please.
I don't know shit about medicine.
Today.
Okay, so you don't really get a good understanding of how these creatures died. It's been so long that they're mostly just skeletons. It's hard to tell what died from just pressure, or what bone breaks are just from pressure and what are from, like, potential combat.
There's four of them, though.
There's four of them.
Who knows? Maybe these are the four spectral things we just killed.
Now I feel kind of bad. They don't look so great. Can I at least do an investigation to see kind of how they're positioned?
I can have you investigate them.
Yeah. See if they just slumped down and died because of despair or someone killed them?
Kinda, like, I can't tell if they got punctured, but I can at least see if they're, like, tired position or if they're, like, surprised position.
You, do investigate, further into these bodies. Some of them do appear to have that same old leaf crown armor. One of them is more distinct than others. It's got the actual helmet that has the insignia on it. Although it's barely noticeable amidst all the rust from the erosion. The others appear to be just commoners or something. They don't have anything special about them as far as military. They just seem to be wearing normal clothes, if now just scraps. There is a set of stairs to the north that descends into murky, heavily obscured water. There is also a door to the south. Well, southeast, near where Mao is.
Well, where do we want to go?
I can swim over there, or we can go through the southeast. So we're probably on the level of the swamp, or like the first level, and that goes to the basement in the water area.
Well, it depends on which side. As we go further south, we're going to be more into the swamp.
Yeah. Let's go through your door right here first. Let's not go down the level yet. Yeah.
Yeah. I'll check it first.
Okay. Make an investigation check.
Hey, Amon, are you still collecting bones and shit?
No, because I don't talk to anyone yet anymore.
Okay. I was just wondering.
I don't do that anymore.
Although, it might be worth it. Do you need to communicate with these people?
It might be important right. Later. Take the guy with the leaf crown helmet.
Okay. Twist.
Twist and snap.
I like that.
You a lovely bunch of coconuts.
You bottle cap off the guy's skull and take it along with the jaw to facilitate potential communication.
Talkies.
Potential talkies.
Okay, to the larynx is where all the effort goes in. Anyway,
Mao has investigated this doorway thoroughly as you guys are discussing this. Mao, it doesn't seem to be locked, although it is stuck, but you do see a large amount of wood rot on this door. There's also little points that are cracks in the wood that you can see muck is starting to seep through.
Yeah,
it seems that this is completely filled on the other side with muck.
Yeah.
Is that the door to the outside?
It's the door to the swamp.
Okay, I guess we gotta get our legs wet. Should I leave this then, since I got the robe of swing cast?
I mean, you can, but we should talk to the dead thing first.
Well, he doesn't have it prepared.
We'd have to take a rest.
He's taking it for later.
Yeah, like a whole day rest.
It's a takeout order. Got it.
Takeout.
Actually, I feel guilty now. I'm just gonna do a quick little prayer here. And I'll just like do a quick little to all the Alorans. I don't know what your destiny held, but hopefully may you find peace and we can figure out the truth in this now dungeon of a fortress.
The points of green light begin to spiral around you as you do this prayer. They seem to ram into your chest and just pass harmlessly through you, almost as if they are angered by this prayer.
What did I do? I was trying to get you guys to find peace.
I don't think they like you, dude.
You're warmongering spirits. Mm.
Okay, I'm gonna try something different. May you find... Okay. Mr. Amon, I need you to maybe get Turn Undead prepared just in case. I'm gonna try something else. To all the lost souls here, may you find your vengeance and have your justice be served.
The spirits slow and become less excited. They start to just wander about after circling you a bit. They are now just wandering about the chamber.
Okay, so they're butt mad. Okay.
These spirits are definitely vengeance spirits, so I don't know. Maybe we can figure out what pissed them off so much.
Splish, splash, splash. Are you guys coming? I thought we were moving.
Yeah. I do a swan dive into here, like dive style and just pass her in.
Okay, it is right. About knee deep, so that's gonna hurt.
Oh no. Wait, if it's knee deep, I would be... Should I just roll, like, acrobatics to see if I could actually pull off, like, a lower level dive?
I mean, you could. No diving. Yeah, that's... Shallow waters.
No, please don't break your neck. Please don't.
Zumasu has been added to the ghosts.
Well, on the other side.
Should be fine.
You leap into the water, and you kind of, like, swoop into, you know, a belly level with the water type of dive, a shallow dive. You don't really take any damage, although you do scrape along the bottom.
I try to do something cool, but my knees rub against the thing already. Oh, I thought it was deeper. What's this door now?
There is a set of other double doors here. These ones bear the same sort of sigils as the last. There is water that has seeped in from underneath the doorway.
I'm trying to see if there's a way to open it.
It seems to open inward. Sorry, out, away from you.
Okay. For legs. In traps.
You investigate the thing up and down for traps. It doesn't seem to have any of the similar mechanisms that the other puzzle had.
I go to open the door.
Let's go. I'm gonna help her push open the door.
Okay, you guys push open the door. It's a bit heavier just because of the water pushing against it, but you are able to open it eventually.
Are we swept away?
No, you are not. The water is disturbed, and there's like a small wave that passes through the room. This looks to be a ruined great hall, once again covered in like knee-deep water. There are piles of rubble in the room, as well as a large leaf stone carved throne on the other side. There is a stairwell leading up to a door on the right-hand side.
Don't sit on the chair.
Don't. I want to sit on the chair.
No, and don't say any of that shit you've been saying to the rest of them, angry ghosts.
Just trying to be polite. I'm just going to investigate the chair, but I won't touch it.
You wade over to the throne, and you kind of look around it. There are like these green pinpricks spiraling around it, casting the room in an eerie green glow. As you investigate the throne, you note that it does seem to be like made of this beautiful Eloran architecture, although it is once again mounted on a strange, like, Mesolithic sort of patterned stairwell that's making up the seat of the throne, and it seems to be an older type of stone, limestone rather than marble. Even at this distance, though, as you look over the throne, a sort of afterimage starts to appear as you look away from it, causing you to dart back, and then a humanoid figure starts to manifest sitting on the throne. It appears to be a slumped over figure wearing heavy armor, and with a sort of leaf-covered crown resting upon their head. They slowly look up at you.
Who comes to this place?
Adventurers?
How's it, Mosu? Don't be rude.
another one comes, trying to reclaim that which we rightfully took, you will die here, Yanti.
Hold on. Wait, Yanti?
I'm gonna claim anything.
Yanti, are you racist, man?
The figure stands up, and as it stands up, several other humanoid figures start to come into existence surrounding you.
Hey man, this is all you. I'm out.
I'm investigating this door.
Okay, Mao, as you see this thing going on, you turn towards the door. It seems to be made out of simple iron. Iron wrought wood. The wood is rotting away like much of the rest of it, although this one is strangely a bit more intact.
Okay.
And combat music.
Here's Johnny.
I guess a bit of time. Talking's a free action.
It certainly is.
What do you have against Yanti, old man?
They all must die. And let's roll for initiative. Let me know when everybody's rolled.
Okay.
I have rolled.
Okay.
I am a slow boy. I am a god of a five. Now is a fast one.
Oh, as Batman once said, we're all slow. We're knee deep in mud.
Okay, Mal, it is your turn.
I'm gonna try and pick this. Or open the door.
Wait, you go in first. Can't you assassinate the guy?
I can. Yeah, I'll assassinate.
I'm not in the initiative. Sorry.
Oh.
Oh, roll. Wait, what? Roll, I guess, for the initiative?
That's weird, because you did roll for it.
Yeah, so, yeah, it shows you. But she's not.
Try it again.
Crash,
I'll set it to 16. That's weird that it's not putting you in. For some reason, it's just not doing it for some people.
Is it because she's outside of the room? Does that make a difference?
I shouldn't.
That shouldn't have any effect. The only thing that would have any effect is they would need to have their character token selected.
Okay.
Yep.
I think I fixed it. Yeah.
Wait.
Thank you.
Okay. So, Mao, you take out, I'm assuming, Cinder Smite. As the figure stands up and points their sword out and causes all these figures to appear, you instinctively take out Cinder Smite and launch a strike. It collides with the figure's side with a small explosion of sparks, dealing 55 damage.
Hey, ugly. Fuck off.
You take a huge chunk out of it. It is going to... well, is that it for your turn, Mal?
Yeah. I have no place to hide. I'm just here in this corner.
At the initiative count of 20, the guard steps onto the water and then drags his sword across the tip of the water surface. And then a sudden shock of electricity runs through the entire room.
God damn it.
Fuck.
Everybody
stairs.
Everybody except for Mao is going to need to make a constitution save.
Is this magical?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm going to say it's going to... Well, no. You just need to make a save.
Yeah, because it's, I'm wearing armor, so that would just negate the advantage.
Yeah. Okay.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, that is pretty good. So you're gonna take half. Everybody else is going to take the full brunt, which is going to be... There it is. 26. So Zumasu, you take 13.
Okay.
Then the others take 26 lightning damage. Boom Crash, it is your turn.
Fucking ow. So.
Yep. Fried chicken.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
I should note that while you guys are in here, the water counts as difficult terrain.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
I forgot to mention that.
Okay. Are these rocks?
They are.
Above?
They are peeking out of the water.
That is good to know. I will... Actually, if they are, then one, two, three. It's as far as I can get, but...
It's closer. Those ones are still partially in the water. The ones with, like, the ripples around them are out, though.
So, like, these?
Yep.
If you're gonna dash up above the top, that's probably not a bad idea.
I can take one more hit. I want to try and smack these guys.
Okay.
So...
You use your Eldritch Blast. And that is gonna hit.
Oh, nice.
These wraiths seem to be wielding swords and shields this time. But this one does get blasted away and takes 5 force.
Okay. I'm going to try and hit that dude next.
That is also a hit.
Oh gosh, minimum damage both times. Shit.
Yikes. Well, at least both of them got hit.
Mm-hmm. I'll take it.
Okay. Is Goose doing anything?
Goose is going to...
Probably have him hover. That'd be a good...
Yeah, I'm
going to
have him hover
safe.
And hover, like, sort of behind the chair.
Okay. Goose soars behind the throne and starts to float around there. It is this sword wraith's turn. This one begins to hover towards Amon. They are all bearing the same old leaf crown armor. This one uses its longsword to attack. And is not... Well, does 17 hit you, actually?
Yeah.
Okay. It is going to deal... 9 slashing damage.
Youch.
It is then going to use its martial fury to make another attack as a bonus action. However, this recklessness gives it gives you advantage on attacks against it. And it misses with its second attack. So,
all right.
Good on you, dumb. Right. It is the High Guard's turn. It is going to, in spite of getting very badly wounded by Mao, it is going to... it's just going to strike directly at Zumasu. It steps just over the water, and is going to make 2 attacks with its longsword.
He doesn't like you. You talk to
apparently.
Him.
Apparently. Oh, that hurt. That did not hurt.
Okay, so that's 1 hit.
That's a few things. Oh, that's a bit of damage.
That's because one of them was a crit.
Okay, hold on. The crit, I'm gonna...
Well, no, it wasn't a crit. It's okay. It's adding double damage automatically in case the crit was one that hit.
Okay.
So now it'd just be 5 plus 8?
Nope, it's just the 5.
Oh, okay.
Although, you do take an additional 1 lightning damage.
Yay!
Okay, it... is going to use its martial fury to make 1 extra weapon attack.
Goddamn fighters! It still missed.
It still misses. This one is charged, supercharged with electricity, which crackles along its blade. Get back here, you filthy snake! You, get them! And the one next to you, Zumasu, takes its longsword and starts to strike. 18 does not hit.
I'm glad I have armor.
It's going to bonus action attack. And another miss. Tis this guy's turn. The High Guard issues a command to that one. Drag that one in. And then the Sword Wraith starts to float over near Mao. It is going to attempt a grapple attack against you. So make an opposed... athletics, or acrobatics, you can choose either.
Yeah, nope, no touch. Nope.
Bad touch.
Ooh. Well, you still manage to succeed against it. It is going to instead just whip out its sword and drag you into the water one way or another. and make an attack.
Rude.
And it misses.
Nope.
All right, Amon, it is finally your turn.
All right, turn undead.
Okay.
Actually, hold on, hold on. I'm gonna go walk around here. Turn undead.
Okay.
Against everyone.
As you invoke the power of your deity, the red skull appears once more. But as the leaf crown guards start to freak out, the high guard slams his sword against his shield. Do not pay attention to this foul creature. And they gain advantage against the turning, but they will all still attempt to save.
Alright.
At least you're in my aura.
That doesn't do anything. Well, not now.
Not now. Do you think the opposite term?
Okay, they all still failed. The High Guard themselves is immune to this.
Alright. I got the small fry. Take care of the head one.
Will do.
Alright.
Alright. In that case, I think I'm gonna follow up with the spirit weapon.
See if you can drag it in. You should be able to now. If it's in folders,
there
it, yep.
It is. Okay.
You got it. Nice.
Bam. It's time to whack. Nope.
It whizzes past the High Guard, who just snarls at you. Okay. It is this guy's turn. He's gonna run away. He can't go towards you, so he just backs up over here. They seem to be treating these walls as, like, something that they can't walk through, in spite of being seemingly spectral. Tsumosu, it is your turn.
Alright, bonus action, Justice Blade. And I'll go for an attack. Just gonna yell out. Actually, I'll attack first.
Okay, 26.
Does a 26 hit?
A 26 does hit.
Sweet. Okay. Ba-dum. D8 Radiant, and I'm gonna smite. It's undead.
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
Ooh.
That could have been more.
Okay. So that's a lot. That is 20.
That's
that
30
is 32.
Damage, right?
Yep. Your sword slams into the creature. You clatter away their shield, and they try to parry, but it's too late. You stab into them with their sword, and your own blast of Hieronius's lightning erupts throughout the area. The High Guard seems to be injured by this. Their own lightning is not quite radiant. Theirs is more lightning-y. Okay.
Second attack.
Does
that hit under normal?
That does not hit. They have 18 AC otherwise.
Okay. I'm just gonna kinda shit-talk it and just be like, you do realize anyone can be a Leaf Crown.
Leaf Crown is an honor reserved for elves only. Mao, it is your turn.
Ah.
Yeah, you kind of squirreled in there.
I am. Hold on, do I actually have the crossbow feat so I don't have a disadvantage on short range attacks?
If you ask, you probably
nope.
Don't.
Yeah, I definitely don't.
Just shoot at the dude.
Well, can I make Fuck. I'll shoot at the big guy. Fuck these guys.
Okay, you do have, disadvantage on... Well, not disadvantage. It has cover.
I mean, if I miss one of them, it's gonna hit the other one, right?
Yep. If it's within the range.
Okay, cool.
Nice.
Okay, even with the cover, that does still hit. Shibuya. That's gonna, and you apply,
sneak attack,
you
right?
Apply sneak attack. Ho, you guys have alpha striked this dude.
he actually hit first, so.
Is this true? We tried talking.
Yeah, we
did try talking. He was being a bastard.
That is 35 damage. Another blast showers you guys in sparks. There's like an explosion in the water as well that sort of sends a mist into the air. The other wraiths are still terrified and trying to run away. Mao, anything else for you?
Bonus action, disengage and run to the chair and stand on top of it.
Okay, you leap into the water, and then the water kind of blunts your fall with a splat as you tumble up onto the throne itself. The green sort of points of light start swirling and spiraling around you, and passing through you in angry anguish.
Oh, get the fuck out of here. Try to swipe at them like flies.
On initiative count 20, the High Guard plunges his sword into the water once again. I'm gonna need everybody except Boomcrash and Mao to make a constitution save. Amon gets Zumasu's bonus.
17.
Shit.
A 17 is successful. I know, right?
A 12 is not.
A 12 is sadly not. So, Zumasu, you take 33 lightning. Amon, you take 17 lightning.
Alright.
Okay.
That could have been better.
Boom crash.
Not a fan of that.
It is your turn. The High Guard seems weakened. His spirit is starting to flicker. You won't get away with this. This is my keep.
Okay.
You climb up onto the rocks, and from this perch, you unleash a blast. Unfortunately, it has cover from the various creatures, and that does end up hitting Zumasu. Roll for damage.
Ah, goddammit.
Wait, what?
You are shooting into melee, and the line goes through Zumasu. So if it's between the threshold of the enemy's AC and the cover bonus, then it does hit Zumasu.
Wait,
that's kind of how I rule that.
Does 19 actually hit me?
It doesn't matter.
Okay. But I get pushed. Where do I get pushed?
God damn it! Of course.
You take 14
damage for you.
And are blasted. Well, I'll say you're blasted through it. It is a ghost. It's cooler that way. But you do have a second attack, and weirdly, Zumasu is no longer in the way.
That hurts.
That one misses as well and hits Zumasu. No, I'm just kidding.
Fuck.
Anything else for you, Boomcrash?
I'm gonna just grump and swear and kick up my feet a little bit.
Okay. Also, Amon, do you need to concentrate on Turn Undead? I didn't really think about
that. I did not see anything about concentration.
Okay. Then this guy is just going to run. It runs off into the corner and cowers. It's finally the High Guard's turn. It is going to do. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when he come for you? Yeah, it's just gonna turn towards Zumasu. Might as well, right?
Ah, fuck.
I'll allow it. With one swipe, Zumasu, you take 10. Slashing damage.
Calm down.
The High Guard continues to walk along the water and strides towards Amon. Your tricks won't work here, you filthy heathen. Filthy undead death nomancer thing. Have at you.
Yeah, I'm sure it'll work.
He mad.
Wow.
he gets buffed when he's at this many hit points, I guess. You're gonna take 18 slashing damage.
Who the heck specs into paladin barbarian?
I don't know. It's going to use a bonus action to make a final empowered attack against Amon. The sword crackles with lightning. Oh my god. At least it's not the crit technically.
Mm-hmm.
But that is a mighty series of rolls. You're going to take 12 slashing plus an extra 2d8 lightning. So that's a grand total of 23 damage from that last hit. And he...
I'm down to 70 hit points.
Better than zero.
It ends his turn. This wraith is gonna run away. Have at you.
I just got here. Like, why are you guys, like... I'm kind of like the pick, the Donald Glover in the Community. That's coming with
the bad timeline.
Yeah.
Amon, it is your turn.
Alright, alright. All point, no edge, sickle strike, you know, with my spear weapon.
Okay, your scythe, spirals towards the high guard from behind. And it doesn't see it coming, it collides with it.
Alright.
I wish I was conscious.
The scythe spirals towards the high guard. You 16. Will pay for invading my home. All heathens will be exterminated from the... It explodes into a blast of lightning. The other wraiths shriek and disappear.
Ugh, it's like looking into a mirror. Anyway.
Glub, glub, right. Glub, glub, glub.
Yeah, let me heal you. I know that's my action for remaining. Okay, so three, so one, two.
Yeah, you just kill people as bonus actions, dude.
3d8, so actually that's 24 plus 4, so 28. You heal 28.
I feel pretty good. To be fair, if I didn't get hit by Boomcrash's thing, it probably would have just unloaded all those attacks on me anyway.
Yep, and then I paid for it.
There is a strange sensation as this rush of wind passes through the area. There are like arrow slits up ahead where a wind passes through, showering over the waters. The little green points of light start to spin and spiral around the throne that Mao is sitting upon. And Zumasu,
as
your eyes flutter awake, the points of light surge towards the throne all at once, seemingly coming from all over the castle. And then they start sinking into the seat of the throne. The throne glows dimly with light before it fades into nothing. Well, not nothing. It's still there. It's no longer glowing.
I'm trying to wonder. We didn't recover any Yuan Ti skeletons around here, right?
You don't see any.
I feel like, if anything, from what I've gathered so far, the original Leaf Crown were hella racist, and I do know that they weren't exactly friends with Yuan Ti. I'll admit it. Our race's history is kind of checkered. So, if they were from that era, that makes sense.
We have a checkered past of slaughtering natives.
I guess, but how long ago was that?
What history-wise, when was... Because by the time I was around was like when they got rid of them, but they must have been fighting them before that, right? Can I just do like a history to see what I kind of remember and pick
Yeah,
up?
You can do that.
Okay.
Oh, is that
In
what the
meanwhile,
15 was?
I cast Death Ward on myself. I need to not die.
I would like to not die. I cast not death on myself. You do. You are warded against the inures of death. Zumasu, you search your brain. You do recall that the fighting with the Yuan Ti did happen for a while before they were finally driven from their native lands in Mullaghmoor.
So, probably not a fan of they probably would have cheered the extermination of my original village, but not of enlisting a paladin. I'm gonna investigate the chair and actually, like, get on a little bit more closer to it now that it's not glowing anymore.
Sure.
I'm still standing on it.
Boomcrash.
Valuable or interesting?
Actually, Boomcrash and Mao, you can make, perception checks while they're doing this.
Nice.
Mao, you are still freaking out about the throne, but Boomcrash, as you're like climbing up onto the second rock to perch out of the water, fluffing up your feathers, you look around the room, And there seems to be a mural on the opposite wall, facing away from the throne. It's a simple, like, tree-looking pattern, but at the top, in big block letters written in common, on each individual block, are the words Themeril. I will write that in the chat.
Thank you.
Neat.
And that's all that says. As far as your investigation of the throne, Zumasu, it's definitely been built upon. Like I said before, the seat of the throne is like this heavy limestone thing with almost steps leading up to it, this big hefty stone block. You see some snake-like patterns on it. And also, I'm going to have you make a religion check.
Okay, 1 second. Sorry, I was opening notes.
Okay. In your time as a Leaf Crown Guard, you've gotten curious about your heritage, and you did learn about the heathen religions, one of which is that of Dendar the Night Serpent, which this seems to have the holy symbol of, although it has been etched and, almost half destroyed, either through force or erosion of a butt sitting on it.
Wasn't Dendar the Night Serpent in the Shrine of Tomochan?
You do remember a serpent god, but I think it might have had a different name. But
I get
gods
this
have many
have
names.
This might have been taken over, so this probably was maybe like a Yawn-Ti fort that got taken over by the Leaf Crown?
Okay, that makes sense. Probably the reason why everything hates you. They're all swirling around you so angrily. What?
Why aren't there any Yawn-Ti guards or shit? Like, I figured those guys would be more vengeful.
I think they're racist, and they probably killed the Yawn-Ti and took over their place.
Does anybody have proficiency with Mason's tools?
Not me.
Okay.
Bonry did.
Bonry did. He could have cunned the shit out of this stone.
We also knew a person who was able to, you know, mold... Well, I don't know if he could do... If they could do this, because it's not mud, but...
Hey, why don't you just take your sword and carve through it? You know, just defame, you know.
Oh,
I mean,
okay, so Zumasu, I guess with your religion check as well, you do intuit that before it was built upon to be a throne, it was probably an altar of some sort.
Okay.
It also looks like. I will have you make a. Well, you got a 21 with your investigation check. So I'm gonna count this as that. The limestone section looks like it wasn't originally here. It looks like it was taken here. The structure itself is very alluring, except for these weird limestone bits, as if they were brought from someplace else and placed here.
Oh, okay. So I get it. They took the spoils from taking over some Yanti's spot.
Yeah, don't forget the plinths themselves, too, out front were limestone and the statues themselves were marble.
Yeah, so this place was built on the spoils of destroying a Yawn-Ti, whatever site. Which probably is cursed as well, to be fair. I don't know, is there any writing or anything on this thing that I could just use in ink and stuff to copy?
There doesn't appear to be any writing left upon this altar, unfortunately.
Alright, I'm just write down the word Themeril. And there's nothing else on the walls, right?
I assume
Booncrash said, look at this, guys.
Although, if Booncrash does point that out, you guys can make history checks.
I do.
It's fairly easy.
I point and hoot.
It's fairly easy, but there's a reward if it's a high check.
I don't finish other people's cultures, as usual, apparently.
Okay.
History.
Booncrash points out, guys, look, Themeril! You guys look at it and just kind of shrug and go back to what you're doing.
It doesn't say cult. Fuck that.
Booncrash, you recognize Themeril as the name of one of your places that you're going to. There's a place that you're on your way to called Themeral Post, though this is obviously not it. You do recall that Themeral did exist in the past, probably closer towards your time. Maybe even a little before. This is probably an older kingdom, also named Themeral.
I point all of that out.
How old are you guys again?
Don't ask.
22.
I mean, years lived or...
Yeah, I'm 23.
Time on this earth.
I forget, did you guys actually mention that you were, like, frozen out of time or what?
They have several times.
I definitely have.
It's come
okay,
up.
Yeah. Okay. So, this is probably back from when you guys were stony people?
Yes. It was like 100 years ago. How am I supposed to know?
Amon and Mao are kind of fiddling with the door as you guys are talking. It doesn't appear to be trapped from Mao's initial investigation, although it was locked.
I'm just kind of hearing on the other side. While you guys are talking, I just want to make sure
okay.
Nothing's going to
fall
through.
That's a percept.
I'm going to poke you and heal you for 10 hit points.
Hey, Amon, do you want some hit points? Amon? Hey, Amon?
Amon shushes you. You can't seem to hear much on the other side of the door.
There you go, Amon. 10 hit points. Then I give you a slap on the back.
Alright, is everyone ready?
Don't forget to add your 10 hit points.
I can try and unlock the door for you, if that's what you're going for.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Yes. Let us
That'll
do
be
that.
A thieves' tools check. Dexterity based.
Sleight of hand with proficiency, because I'm proficient in thieves' tools. Sorry.
Okay. The door is pretty easily opened. The lock was pretty rusty. On the other side, you find what appears to be someone's bedchambers.
Oh, neat.
There's a bed complete with a canopy. There's a dresser. One of those zigzaggy... I forget what those are called. The things to...
Divider.
Dividers, yeah, divider. There's also, like, a vanity with a broken mirror, a stool, a set of cabinets, and a small wooden chest. Most is... Although free of muck and condensation and humidity, it's very dry and dusty in here.
Are we alone? I look through my robe of eyes.
You do seem to be alone.
I'm gonna check the vanity to see if I can find anything.
Okay. I'm
looking for any papers.
You start looking through the vanity. Make an investigation check.
I hide behind the divider so I can scare Boom Crash when she walks in.
Boo.
Okay, I walk Boo. In. But you didn't do like a hide check or anything, so I'm going to jump and hoot and then tackle you with a hug because that's your punishment.
Uh-huh. All right, I give up, uncle.
I'm just gonna lie the foot of the bed.
Okay.
How comfy is that bed?
I mean, it's pretty
We're
dusty.
Not living here.
I mean, we could take a rest here. We certainly earned it.
Z.
What's in the vanity so far?
You haven't found much. You just opened the drawers. There is a small little book covered in dust. It has a small, tiny little lock on it.
Mal, can you break this lock?
Huh? You mean pick it?
Break the lock.
Pick it. Got it. It probably breaks it. It's old.
It actually does. It was fairly easy to just snap it open just by fiddling with a little latch. It opens up, dust kind of pours out. It's an old, what looks to be diary.
I'm gonna start reading this thing.
Okay, it's gonna take you a while to read through it, so other people can look about the room if they wish.
Okay.
Chest. Boxes. There's the bookshelves.
I'm gonna
right?
lay on the damn bed.
Or look underneath the bed.
I'm sitting on top of this bed to read the book.
Okay, you sit on top of the bed. Dust poofs out everywhere. A few spiders start crawling out. Yeah. Amon, you look underneath of the bed. It doesn't look like there's too much down there, but make an investigation check.
Nope. I see nothing.
Yeah. Worth a shot. Mao is investigating the chest?
Yes.
Sure. You open up the chest, and an initial, look through. Doesn't really need a check or anything. But you do check for any sort of secret, things there. You don't really find any. However, inside of the chest, there are a lot of, old rotten silk garments, but among them, there's also a, amongst them, there's, like, you can unwrap one of the silk, things, and you find a sort of bone and silver instrument, a kalimba. It's probably worth something, because it was finely made.
I start playing with it.
Start plucking on the kalimba, which is one of those, like, metal thumb instruments. Still sounds nice.
I say keep it.
It's like a little child's toy, except I'm very enamored by it, and just like, ooh, interesting.
Start getting a proficiency in it. Get the performance checks in.
I will be proficient in a kalimba!
Okay, Boomcrash, are you looking through anything?
Gonna look through this vanity.
Okay, Zimalsu looked through there, but you try and check it more thoroughly.
Yeah.
I did poorly.
Okay. Also, I just like rifling through people's drawers.
That's fine. It's a valiant profession. you start rifling through these drawers. Doesn't look like you've found too much. Looks like there was a small, nice-looking golden comb in there. It's a little rusty. Well, not rusty, but, you know, it has some gross stuff on it. But you scrape it off, and it's probably worth something, you venture.
Okay, I take it.
Sure. Can I get intelligence checks to figure those out? Actually, do you have Identify, Boomcrash?
Yes,
actually,
I do.
Identify only detects magic, doesn't it? Well, they don't emanate magic. But I can get investigation checks from whoever has the highest to find the value of those. Zimalsu is still engrossed in this book, trying to decipher the dense cursive. Boomcrash, very good roll. I'm going to say that you intuit that the comb is probably worth about 10 gold pieces, but the Kalimba is probably worth a great deal more, being a nice piece of art. It's probably worth about 750.
What's a Kalimba?
It's like a little thumb instrument that you pluck. Allie will probably find one, a gif of one or something.
Thanks. Okay.
Zimalsu, as you finally start getting the gist of what was going on in this diary, it seems to be probably not the person that was living in this room, but it does appear to be one of their handmaids. This appeared to be a noble of sorts, and it described the handmaid's day-to-day duties, doing work for Linessa Morristhane.
Is that familiar?
It does not sound familiar to you. But they appear to be a merchant that was well-to-do in Themeral, and had worked their way to the top of the echelon there, and earned their right to pretty much live in the main keep.
So a wealthy merchant took residence in this spot.
It also seems to talk about the handmaid's suspicions about Linessa, thinking that they were doing some sort of illicit dealings. They seemed to be meeting a lot with a new stranger to Alore. They've made several visits so far, and they don't seem to have the best of intentions. They always speak in private whenever this Aetoris Volidel visits.
You've been trying to mess up Alore since before I was born?
He's an elf.
Hey.
Do you call this out at all?
Yeah, I'm just gonna be like, guys, this thing mentioned Aetoris in not a pretty light.
I sort of like dramatically look over and I'm like,
I give them the gist of what happened. Dun, I'm just saying, like, dun, it seems to be the maid's diary or whatever, but the lady of this, the merchant lady of this keep who took up residence here because, you know, merchants. Mm-hmm. The maid did not like the Satoris guy who was apparently making some sort of shady dealings all the times around here. It didn't seem to really have the interest of Alore when he was doing so. I'm going to hold on to this, but this is interesting. Right?
This is definitely good.
There's actually if you keep reading.
I'm going to keep reading.
You keep reading up towards the end. It says that their suspicions seem to have been confirmed. My lady was, unfortunately, tragically murdered. They say by poison. One that kills very quickly, but was just able to be detected. Her remains were interred in Themeral Gardens to the north, in the family crypt. Although her daughter survived her, she was taken to live with her relatives.
Where did they live?
It doesn't say.
Damn it, but the family crypt is up north at the actual Themeral Keep we're headed for.
You're not sure, but you would have to head far to the east if you were to actually hit Themeral Post.
So we'd have to go off trail.
Seems that way.
What was the name of the lady?
I put it in the the Roll20 chat. Okay, Linessa Morris Thane. She is described as a wealthy human merchant noble.
Okay. I'm just collecting my thoughts.
Although she had many enemies, all of my suspicions point to this Atorus as the culprit, though I cannot speak out against this figure. It is far too risky.
That's about right, asshole.
This is an interesting development. Is there anything else that she's saying? Because I'm trying to see also if there's anything on the guy who was ghosted here.
You don't seem to find that much. There are some vague mentions of the Aloran Guard here, the Leaf Crown, but they aren't really... haven't done anything suspicious, or they haven't been kept up with by this handmaiden. So they don't really detail any of the military aspects of the structure here.
I still can't figure out why they decided to just stay here as wraiths. That's dumb.
Mm.
Okay. I'm gonna hold on to this diary. Maybe I can reference it later.
Sure, you hold on to the diary.
Did we check that dresser thing over there yet?
You didn't.
Alright. I'm gonna check under the bed. Since I've been sitting on it this whole time, somebody else can check the dresser.
I think Amon is checking under the bed.
Yeah, but he didn't find anything.
Oh, okay.
I just figured I was sitting on it this whole time.
You were.
Okay.
Is that for the cabinet?
That's for the bed.
Oh, for the bed? You don't find too much on the bed.
No. Alright, I'm gonna take... How are the pillows looking, actually?
They're not looking great. They're very old, probably filled with downy feathers, but they've started to rot.
Damn it.
It's downy mold.
I'm gonna have to wash my armor.
Blit.
Alright, let's check that cabinet. I have pretty good investigation so far.
The cabinet, doesn't have much of use inside of it, although you do find, a crumpled up piece of paper. It seems to show, a symbol that, relates to that of the throne. It looks like the Sigil of Dendar.
Did I do a history check or something on that? Or is that a religion check?
Well, you already recognize the symbol. There is a arrow that seems to be tracing down its length, starting from its head and onto its tail. It's an Ouroboros sort of symbol, although it's more angular and geometric.
Oh, wait, is that the snake god thing?
Yes.
Oh, okay, got confused for a second.
I'll be back.
That's kind of weird that this is here. I don't know, I'm gonna take the piece of paper and keep it. I didn't find much in here except this guy's and I showed them the paper. I think it relates to the drone. Anyone else want to check anything else out?
After a thorough search of the room, there's not much else here.
Are we taking a rest here for an hour?
You can.
Yeah, I'll say a short rest so I can get some health back.
Okay. You guys take a short rest.
Alright, let me spend some hit die. That could have been better.
I mean, it's still pretty good. Well, I guess it's not that good.
I'll be fine. I'll be fine with that. It's average.
Alright. You guys rest up a bit before heading back out. Do you guys do anything in the next room?
I don't know what to do with this piece of paper. I'm gonna examine the throne again with this.
Make an investigation check.
See if I can figure out where it is on the throne, and see if anything moves or sort of. I don't know.
You do find it. There's one on the front step of the throne, I guess, like where the back of your legs might be, as well as one eroded one in the seat of the throne.
I don't know, does anything move? Can I, like, sit in it and push something? Recline, or does the throne come off?
The throne does not recline.
Damn it.
Sadly, it is made of stone and not of mechanized nature. But you don't really find too many moving parts on the throne. You start kind of jerking it around and nothing seems to work.
We should probably just leave. You know, we still have places to be.
I suppose. I wonder why they felt the need to bring these stupid slabs all the way over here from wherever it was, though.
Probably to make a point.
I guess.
Mao, did you want to try and take a crack at it?
Sure. What would you like me to roll?
I guess investigation. Zim also just seems to be taking a interest in it.
This is how it's done.
Get please out of the way.
With the information, you kind of like snatch the paper out of Zumasu's hand, like annoyed that we're not moving on. You kind of look at it, you look at the throne, you bend down near the front section, and you can see that there is a sort of seam along the edges of this symbol. You follow the arrow with your finger, painting down the snake's trail. It sort of winds before reaching back at the tail that it's biting on. And as you do this, the eye of the snake glows, and the entire front section spins back inside of the throne, revealing an identical one that is encrusted with gemstones.
Ooh.
Nice.
They are emerald and rubies. Half and half.
Oh, okay. So this thing was a safe as well? Weird.
All right. Grab them and let's go.
There's about 20 in total.
20 emerald and rubies.
10 of each.
Somebody appraise these for value?
Sure. Make an int check, our local appraiser wizard.
Okay. Our local shiny expert. However I can.
We brought in our shiny expert to see how much these things are going to go for on the market.
It's probably going to be constitution, damn it. Not great. They're shiny. I like them.
They are pretty shiny. They're probably worth, at best, about 40 gold pieces each.
Okay.
Where's still a lot.
Can we put it in the storage cart? Or you have the party bank. You can.
I can keep track of it. So, okay. Rubies?
10 rubies, 10 emeralds.
40 G each.
Okay. Rubies. 40 G. then.
There, put it all in the roll 20 as well.
Thanks.
Okay. You guys start heading out. Do you guys want to do anything before leaving this place?
I want to say a prayer again.
God damn it.
Okay.
Right before we leave the first room, I want to say a prayer in that room with the statues.
Okay. I'm gonna have I guess Amon and Zumasu attempt medicine checks. Just as you guys pass through this room. It's very difficult, but just in passing.
Okay.
They died alright.
Yeah, they did. With some new information, Amon, as you move past one of the corpses that seems to be wearing just common clothing, you do note that their canines are actually fangs. One of these corpses is that of a Yonti pureblood.
Ah, okay, so...
It was very difficult to notice, but you took a second look at the corpses.
Also,
upon
I
passing
your,
through.
Also, description, the canines appear to be fangs. It's like, water appears to be wet.
Yeah, well, they were more like more like pointed snake fangs rather than wolfy or mammalian fangs.
You basically then look at me and go, his teeth like yours.
Hey, do you want me to rip this head off too?
Just take the fangs.
You need the head. Take the head. Yeah.
All right. Give it a twist, a flick of the wrist.
I'll do it this time. You're not Yonti.
You don't get to do this. I get to do this. Zumasu snaps off the neck. Okay.
By the way, speak with undead cost money, or what are the resources needed for it?
Nope.
What?
It doesn't cost resources.
To speak with undead? I was just wondering if we needed any to set aside any supplies or something for it.
Let me check.
I don't think it does.
Alright, on the other side, I'm just gonna start doing a prayer and be like, to all these unfortunate spirits who felt the need to take it upon themselves vengeance, I hope that now you may find rest, and to all the unfortunate violence that occurred here, I hope it will end on peaceful terms now.
There isn't really any response. You guys solemnly leave this sunken keep and head back to where the phantom steed was disappeared from. Booncrash begins summoning their steed, and Zumasu, you just kind of feel a rush of wind through your pale white hair, stricken from your past resurrection. And you resummon your steed, and you guys start heading off.
I actually can't. I don't have the spell slot.
You do not summon your steed. It just is there.
Okay, cool.
Just
cool.
Isn't there, sorry.
You guys camp in the haunted castle then?
I mean, we could. I'd be fine with camping out here to get spell slots back.
You can if you want to.
And using up the rest of my lay on hands to get some health back.
What up, you guys?
Whatever we do, we just need to make sure that we're not staying in the dark.
I mean, a keep
it's
wouldn't be
pretty
the worst
dark
place
everywhere.
To stay.
Yeah, well, we should get a fire going and some stuff, and I don't know, if it's nighttime, just put some manacles on me or something, please.
I think we already established that whatever happened was something beyond our normal control.
Yeah, no, I get
but just
that.
In case.
Just in case.
You,
okay.
Take some precautions and make sure that, you guys are well lit. You kind of rest on top of the keep, just to get on solid ground for a night.
Okay.
Before making
and
your
I'm gonna,
way back.
I'm gonna spend all my spell slots and lay on hands then to do some healing, so let's see how much I can do. 25 hit points back.
Okay, and then we're still doing the weird long rests. So you guys can choose to get back your spell slots, your hit points, or your hit dice.
Yeah, I'm definitely doing my spell slots because I'm spending my spell slots to get my hit points back.
Yep. It's fair. You guys have that exploit.
Alright. I got 17 back. I'm full health again.
Anyone else need more health?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
Okay. Oh,
actually, let's do this.
And roll training quest on me.
Who has single target evocation spells they can target me with?
Do smites count?
That's not a spell.
Okay. Wait, what about like blinding smite type stuff?
If it says evocation, then yeah.
Okay, just any kind of zappy spell, just anything that can directly target me.
I don't think the smite technically
Elder's Blast?
Does. That's in a spell attack.
Never mind. I need something with spell levels. I'm trying to charge my Rudder Absorption. None of you guys are
helping. Okay, yeah, hold on. Let me look.
Witch Bolt, Fireball...
Fireball's an area. God. Just... something that...
Witch Bolt? I can do Witch Bolt.
Single target.
Alright. Does that mean once?
If you want it to be a continuous thing, as long as we're
It won't because work.
It won't.
Okay.
It'll absorb and become once.
Okay. So I'll just
bam. That. Oh no, I absorb it.
Okay.
You hold out your rod, Amon, and boom crash sort of Emperor Palpatines it towards the rod, which absorbs it much like a lightsaber might.
Oh, and I can do shatter, so that's a level 2.
Well, that does not target.
Oh, damn it.
You can target the area under Amon and it'll explode.
Brandings? I do not have Brandings quite prepared.
Okay, all of you can get the hell away from me. You guys are dangerous. You guys don't know your own.
Hey, can you guys hit me with spells? Yeah, okay.
I'm gonna have Brandings Smite prepared for you because I can use that as an evocation.
Yeah, no.
That's not gonna work either.
I can just keep on doing Witch Bolt and take...
like every short rest.
Yeah. So, we already did it.
Okay. I got enough.
How many charges do you want? Because I can give you a few.
No, I'm good. I'm good.
Yeah, don't want to overcharge it.
Hey, I'm on tiny up. I'm healing
you
for more.
We've gone past that.
Okay, good. Make sure.
The rest...
You got that extra HP.
The rest passes without event.
How's my higher level... cast only one extra, god damn it. So you got but if you weren't taking it, you were getting your spell slots, I'm assuming, you get 20 or you get 18 health back as well. One extra spell slots.
Okay. Cool. Where are you guys heading? North of you guys is the road. Though if you want to search for this strange Themeral Gardens, you can also attempt to do that. Although that
I'm
is uncharted
that
territory.
That wouldn't be contrarian, because I kind of want to figure out what happened. Also,
I'm a little curious. I admit.
Yeah, at this stage, we actually have clues, so if you guys want to do that, I do not object.
I mean, if we can get proof that Atorius is a shithead, that's probably good for our cause.
That is very useful, yeah.
As if he hasn't already killed off everybody.
I don't know. There's a possibility this lady still exists as a merchant, her daughter or whatever.
She's a human. She's dead.
No, I meant like relative, like the granddaughter or whatever. If the lady had relatives, they'd probably want vengeance, and we might have an ally we don't know about.
Or you could be putting somebody else at risk. I'm just throwing that out there. You're mentioning names. Maybe they're trying to keep it secret because it keeps them safe, and you're gonna totally fuck up their life. Just throwing that out there. Some people like to leave the past in the past.
I suppose we're kind of need all the help we can get. Let's head that direction. My vote.
Alright.
I resummon Gregory.
I have no real objections.
Same.
You start to head north and find the path of the road again. But you start to head off the road to go further north. It takes an extra day of travel as you do, although there are no encounters of import, mostly because you probably pass the road at a perpendicular instead of parallel. Okay, so I'm gonna have you guys make a survival check to try and find a long forgotten path. Mao, as you guys like start walking for a while, you guys are like, when are we gonna find signs of this weird like place, and then Mount points to an old stone sign that says Themeral Gardens, and then has an arrow pointing ahead.
Is this it?
Oh, yeah. Good job, Mal.
Weird.
And wow, with yet another day's travel, well, it's not so much a day, it's more like several hours across the murky, swampy area. You find, like, hints of possible foundations of long-forgotten cottages or perhaps farms, but now it's nothing but stones. It's like when you're walking in the woods and you find a random, like, boundary area.
Yeah.
The
property lines.
But none of these seem to be this ephemeral gardens. Eventually, you do come upon a strange iron-grated fence that has, like, these points coming out surrounding what appears to be an old graveyard. However, there is something unusual going on here. There are stakes in the ground. Each has a skull driven upon it, and their eyes glow dimly of green with a mist that looms out of it. You guys hear voices up ahead, or rather, a voice. It's, like, sort of gruff and deep, and shouting. How do you guys approach this?
Stealthily for me.
Fair enough.
Sure, I guess.
Are you guys all going, or is Mao going up ahead?
I'm
sending my boy.
Goose?
Yep.
To take a little goosey gander?
Yep, he's gonna take a gander.
Here, don't enable
Yeah, I'll just let you guys go ahead.
Okay.
You guys
go ahead. Mao, with your stealth check. Oh, what did you say, Mao? Amon?
You guys want me to come along?
Mao just looks at you and goes, preferably not, unless you're quiet.
Okay, fine. You guys go ahead.
Okay.
Bring them back. Have...
Mao starts padding along the swampy
ground.
Oh,
wait, I'm gonna give you the walkie-talkie stone.
Okay.
That's fair.
You hand over the stone quietly before Mao leaves. Mao kind of, like, tucks it behind, like, their scarf, like, near their ear. And let's take you there. Mao, you are hiding behind a tombstone, and you guys are maybe 15 feet off of the map in some brush. Goose kind of just perches on a tombstone, being an unassuming raven. You guys see this pale white, long white-haired humanoid figure. They are clad in black armor covered with spikes. There are three skeletons that they are yelling at. The skeletons are struggling to pull open the door to a mausoleum. Mao, as you approach, and Goose can also hear this, this person is shouting at the skeletons, "Open that door, you idiots! What did I make you for? Come on! I'm not going to sully myself with opening a stupid tomb. Don't make me come over there."
I'll whisper and relay information back to Zumosu.
Okay.
Do you want us to get close?
I mean, it wouldn't hurt.
Alright, I'm gonna get on my horse so I can... Are we just gonna try and take out the guy?
I'm gonna ask Goose to go up here. So.
Okay.
Have my back, I was gonna at least approach or walk past. I don't know. We don't know what he's doing.
Goose perches on top of the mausoleum. This figure then calls over to another skeletal warhorse shrouded in necrotic energy. He just whistles, and it starts, like, shambling over to him. Here. And he tosses a rope around the thing's neck and starts drawing it towards the mausoleum.
I'm gonna mount my horse, and I'm gonna ride over, and I'm just gonna tell him, okay, do you want us to come in and just go after him? Because I can get on my horse and charge him.
We don't know what he's doing. You don't need to kill everything you see.
Okay, I'm gonna ask Goose to use his mimicry trait to say, hey, sexy.
whose voice are they replicating?
A Taurus.
Sure, let's go with that.
Hey, sexy.
Oh, I hate it.
The Dark Knight kind of like looks up at the skeleton and goes, "What?" And he just starts looking around. Who said that? And he draws his sword, or rather a halberd.
Goose does a wolf whistle.
Sorry?
Goose does a wolf whistle.
This is irritating. Show yourself. He's going to actively make a perception check. There we go. Oh. He doesn't detect Mao, because they got a 30. Mm-hmm. But he does detect where the noise is coming from. He looks up at Goose, and just narrows his eyes. You. What do you want? Who sends you? He points his glaive up at you.
What you doing?
My business is my own. I asked you a question. Who sent you? Are you of the master? If so, you should be able to prove it.
Call me Daddy.
Okay, I should be more specific.
I'm sorry, I can't help myself.
No, this is good. Do it.
Good.
I assume your master must be somewhere nearby, you strange familiar. Show yourself, he starts looking around.
Goose just sort of hops around.
Blast. Spread out. Find this interloper. They obviously mean us ill. The skeletons stop prying at the door and start spreading out around the graveyard. The knight mounts his horse and gets sucked inside it, apparently. There we go. He mounts his steed and starts circling around the place.
He's gonna say, or Goose is gonna just sort of follow after.
Like float 30 feet above sort of thing?
Yeah, yeah. He's gonna be like close enough to dive bomb, but far enough away that he's not actually at risk.
Okay.
I'm on my horsey, by the way.
He's paying the familiar no mind, and lets it get as close as it needs to. Mao makes a new stealth check, which is what I was going to ask for. I'm going to ask for the rest of you also to make stealth checks, as he comes slightly closer to you, but you're all still in, like, a thicket.
Does it make a difference if I'm on the horse?
Yeah, I'm going to have the horse make a check as well.
Okay.
So just roll a d20.
I'm probably gonna fail this. Probably at least I can gallop. Yeah, I failed this.
As the skeletal warhorse with this black knight ridden upon it starts heading near the thicket, Gregory needs to be calmed down as he starts rearing. And you just kind of like pat him.
He had better stealth than I did.
He did, and you do quiet him down quickly, but you trying to quiet him down has actually ended up making more noise as you snap on a twig. The dark figure points his glaive into the thicket. You! Show yourself!
I'll step out with my horse. He already found me.
You found me.
Hail.
Hail and well met, my dudes.
Yeah.
Who are you? Yon T.
I'm Taco. Taco from TV.
Adventure. I heard there was nice tombstones over here. Possibly some interesting treasure. Didn't expect to run into anybody over here.
Well, you have. This is my haunt. Leave, and you will be spared.
I would like to try and attack. And I'm going up to the dude as he's being distracted by them. You guys keep talking.
All right. I mean, multiple hands make faster work.
if there's nice treasure here, you know, I'd be willing to help you out.
You would only hinder me. My skeletons and I have no need for your help. Mao, you sneak up right behind this dude on the horse.
Knock him off his horse. And then, I don't want to kill him, but I do want to...
You can do assassinate non-lethally.
Yeah.
Kill the horse.
Could kill the horse.
Or just assassinate non-lethally.
Yeah, I say assassinate non-lethally.
Alright, you lunge onto the horse, climbing up the side of the rib cage, almost like a ladder, using your footholds, and then you stab into this figure's back.
A hilt to the head, but okay, that's fine.
Well, you try to find a chink in his armor.
That's fair.
And kind of, like, shove off a piece of it, and then, like, sink the bell of your scimitar, like, right into the side of it. Yeah, that hits his AC. He's going to take a cool 47 damage. Who dares? He looks at the tiefling, just like hopping down off of his horse. You will all pay for this insolence. And I think we're going to have to roll for initiative at this point.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe.
Okay. Where is my character sheet? Did I roll well? I should never ask that question. Look at all of you with actual dex bonuses.
And have all the skeletons go at once.
Oh man, I can't wait to turn undead on all those skeletons.
I know.
You might go too.
Okay.
Wait, what'll happen to the warhorse? Just rides off on a scared horse.
Same thing that happens to other undead. Let's go into descending order. And Mao, it's weirdly your turn still.
I guess you're leaving me no choice. Oh no.
Okay. Yeah, you go in for another attack. Are you still trying to attack non-lethally?
Yeah.
That's still close, yes.
Okay, that's gonna hit.
No, no one's nearby for sneak attack.
Yeah, you don't have sneak attack, but you did get that assassinate off, which was huge. Okay, and they are not immune to the necrotic damage, so they do start to bleed from that.
Is he a human, or what does he look like?
He just looks like a very pale, elf-like figure.
Oh, elf.
Okay, is that it for you, Mao?
Yes. I guess I'm just there to impose disadvantage.
Like
for flanking?
Flanking, yes. Okay. As you guys stab into the knight, well, Mao does anyway, the knight's eyes begin to glow a sickly green. Looks like we're going to need a bit more to help with this. And then two of the nearby skulls on the pikes start to rise off. They slide off with little holes stuck in their heads. And let's put these guys on the right layer.
Come on,
they
man.
Start shrieking and laughing maniacally. This one near Mao is actually going to act next.
That's just bad craftsmanship.
It is going to it is going to shoot its fire rays at Mao. It shoots a fire ray out of its eye. One out of each.
Fire, you say?
Yep, they both miss though.
No.
And it's just going to cackle and fly around here, which does provoke an attack of opportunity if you wish to take it. Okay, you do. And that does hit for 10 slashing.
Be gone, Thought.
Okay, next turn. Wish I had the combat tracker thing. Okay, it's the warhorse's turn. This knight is going to instruct it to move. Take care of them, my minions! He's going to rush off this direction, back towards the mausoleum, and his mount just sort of rears back and whinnies with a spectral whinny. And it is his turn. They conveniently go next to each other. It's going to... Okay. Sorry, he's got spells, so I actually have to look at him. Yep, he is going to cast Ray of Sickness off at Mao, which is going to need a spell attack from him. He's going to add plus 3. Okay. Well, it's a natural one. He shoots a green ray, that flies right past Mao's face. Pretty far away, though. The skeletons all move as well. This is just Chris Plays game. This dude's gonna shamble over to Mao and make a short sword attack. There it comes. 10 misses. This skeleton is going to kind of just take a little step forward and shoot with a short bow at Mao. And miss again.
Misses.
This other skeleton is going to walk over here, right near
his daddy.
And short bow. Finally, a hit for 6 piercing damage, which it is a missile now, but you have used your reaction already.
When?
To make an attack of opportunity against the flame skull.
Oh, yeah. You were right.
Amon, it's your turn.
All right.
You are about 30 feet away from this action. I didn't have enough map, sadly.
Okay. So, I'm going to spend my movement to get here. I'm going to spend my key point to dash.
Okay.
I say the right. Yes? No?
What?
Hello?
I heard you say you used a key point to dash. That's all I heard.
So is it fair for me to move around into the map now?
Yeah, you can. Sorry, you must have cut out.
Okay.
Did you Naruto run?
Yes. and then I do a big clap into channel divinity. The turn undead. Now, if any of the undead are CR 1 or below, they're instantly destroyed.
Okay, and I think this... Feet. Yep, so it pretty much gets the guys near you. They're gonna try... Okay.
30 feet.
Okay, they do have advantage against magical effects. So this is presumably magic. So a 15 and a 17 for the flame skulls. Does the 15 fail?
Yeah, 15 fails.
Okay. The skeleton. Is destroyed. It crumbles apart in a bloody red mist. Meanwhile, the second one was this dude. It is going to start fleeing. Actually not sure which icon is the fear one, but oh well. Okay, anything else with your turn, Zumosu?
That's me.
Or Amon.
Oh, sorry, Amon. Boomcrash.
No.
Okay.
It's 30 feet to get onto the map.
Yep, but Boomcrash does have range.
Okay, yeah, it's, so I'll move up to get onto the map, I guess.
Okay.
And then I'll just try and take out the little guys. I assume a 23 hits.
It does. It is blasted 10 feet away. It does a little spin in midair. And takes 8 force.
Oh, wow. These things are tougher than I expected. Mm-hmm. Attack the same one. 13?
That...
No.
Hold on, I'm not sure. That just barely hits.
Mm, nice. 12.
12 force.
So 20 total.
Awesome. The thing is just starting to look bloodied. Its jaw has, like, flown off, and it is still laughing, and fire is still billowing from it. It's just half the skull it used to be. Anything else from you, Boongresh?
Nah. I'm good.
Okay. The flame skull is going to, billow over here, over the iron grate. It then starts cackling madly as its eyes light up with a reddish fire this time, and it shoots out a little spurt from its eyes that lands right about here. Zimalsu is not on the map, but the rest of you are in range of a fireball that explodes outward.
Awesome.
Everybody, including Goose, is going to make a dexterity saving throw.
I'm pretty sure Goose is just going to discorporate.
Yeah, I think Goose is popped. Oh, baby. I'll be back later.
Bye, babe.
Mao, with evasion, that's no damage for you. Mm-hmm. You backpedal out of the way, kicking up some swamp grass to just eat the flames. Booncrash, that's a success. You take half damage. And Amon, I'm going to need a save from you as well.
Okay, sorry about that. Me.
Okay, you also take half damage. Just adjust the dice. Pretty good rolls, everyone. 23, so you guys take 12 each. Except for, you know, Mao and Zimasu. And Goose discorporates. Okay, Flame Skull is done. Zimasu, it is your turn. It is 30 feet to the map.
Not my pony. Does the pony move before me, or?
I didn't have its initiative, but it can go at the same as you. Okay. I'll go find it.
Pony wanna ride to other pony. Pony can make 2 move actions, so that's 20 feet.
Definitely.
The pony would just try to get up to the other guy.
Okay. I'll drag you over. You pretty much can make it.
Hi there. I'm actually a paladin. I'm going to attack him with Justice Blade.
He snarls at you as he recognizes the radiant light. Well, then you're going to make this extra tasty.
Son of a bitch.
You swing at him. Hi, I'm a paladin. And you whoosh through the air. he just taps your blade as it dances away. Not a skilled one, I see.
I don't usually fight on horseback.
Then I see... It seems that you are at a disadvantage here. Ow! And then you just finally get a glancing blow on him. Make
there
an attack.
There we go, Gregory. That's the radiant.
3 slashing. Plus
He's
2
not
radiant.
Undead, right?
He is not.
Just a normal elf. Okay.
That is smiting for 21 radiant. Nice.
Okay. That's not awful.
Not liking this. Not one bit.
If you give up now, we'll show you some mercy.
Never. Orcus would have my head. Mao, it's your turn.
Orcus?
Did.
They look good. They look good. There's a little fireball over there. Let's go move and hide behind another stone and hit the dude on the horse.
Okay, you tumble over there and hide behind a broken tombstone. That definitely beats their passive. Although, that doesn't quite hit them. The arrow whizzes past. You took a pot shot, hoping that it would just hit, but it misses.
Boo! Immature.
Okay. Second Flame Skull's turn, it is going to run away in terror. Zimasu, a Flame Skull whizzes past you, provoking an attack should you choose to take it.
If the guy on the horse moves away from me, I can attack him, right?
Theoretically.
Yeah, I'm not gonna take it. I'm just gonna save it for him.
Okay. Tis the warhorse's turn. It just kind of moves a little closer to... Actually, it doesn't need to move closer. It's just going to take a... Just gonna move a little bit over here. It has a glaive, so he can actually hit you from a fairly good distance. And on his turn... The dude is going to cast Blinding Smite.
I didn't think he'd have that.
Oh, that's not the right constitution save. Either way, he slashes at you with his glaive. I'm gonna need you... Well, I need to hit with an attack first. Let's not get ahead of myself.
It's charged up so that... Oh yeah, that hits. Damn.
Okay, so you're gonna take... 7 slashing, and then I need to read how this spell works because it didn't tell me what it did. Just did it.
I take the damage, and then if I fail to save, I get blinded.
Okay, so you take the damage anyway, so you're going to take 16 because that was the first roll. And then I'm going to need you to make a con save.
It's magical, right?
This is magic. You do have advantage.
I'm fine.
Yeah. You're fine. You are not blinded.
Hey, are you a paladin? What kind of paladin raises undead?
He is also going to smite on this attack as well.
Oh, that's rude.
Just a normal smite, you know. You know the type. I think you're familiar with it.
I'm mad at this guy now.
He's going to deal a bonus. Let's do a max level smite. 2, 3, 4. That's 4d8s.
Fucking roll 4 8s.
It's a 20 total.
That's not a bad average. It's literally average.
Okay.
Now I know what it's like to unload all your spells.
Indeed. Second attack. Miss. Third attack.
Why did you get 3?
A hit. For 14 slashing. And let's do another smite. This time for 3d8. You take an additional 27 damage from this third hit that connected. He's done with his turn. Amon, it is your turn.
It seems you can actually fight. And not just have your skeletons do it for you.
Yes, well, they're more like dressing.
Okay. It's a shame that I can't get closer to get this skeleton, but, Turn Undead.
Jeez, I need to look into Turn Undead. Can you do it, like, twice and have it affect both instances at the same time?
Okay, let me just check.
It's a divine action, so you only get a certain amount per day, I believe.
I know it's a certain amount per day, but if he does one and then does it again on new Undead, does the previous one still get frightened?
Okay, use your turn ability, you choose which effect to do, effect saving throws, there's nothing that says I can't just keep on spamming it.
Okay.
So, turn undead.
Okay, so it doesn't get that guy, that's the guy that I'm doing it again. Okay, so the warhorse failed, the skeleton failed, that guy got dead. The warhorse is also CR 1/2, so that got dead. The knight, or blackguard as it were, collapses on the ground, prone. You bastards. Didn't know you were clerics and paladins. No, it doesn't.
Okay.
It's forced movement. Anything else with you, Amon?
Let's do a spear weapon because that seems to be the best thing because everything is immune to necrotic damage. So I'm going to spear weapon and bonk him.
Okay, make it that spell attack. That hits.
Okay.
for 7 damage, plus 4?
Four, yeah.
Okay, 11 damage. The scythe swipes through him. Didn't realize that your cleric was a death cleric. That's my job as well. He sort of struggles back to his feet. He's still prone for now. Booncrash, it is your turn.
Okie dokie, Artichokey.
A man of the fellow trade, I see. What are you doing here?
Doing what I do best. Raiding graves for the master.
Okay. Should we just focus on the big boy?
I say focus on the big boy.
Yep.
He is prone, okay. So he has, or you have disadvantage on attacks against him right now. Ranged attacks.
But if you hit him, doesn't it do extra damage?
Nope.
Nope, there's nothing about that.
No.
If a creature is unconscious, it's an automatic crit. And that's only with melee attacks. That's different.
Okay, I'm moving closer and just gonna try. Why not?
Okay, disadvantage. That misses.
Okay.
It skids off of his armor.
Nope.
Yet another one just blasts into the marsh mud nearby. Okay, is that it?
Yep, that's it.
Okay. It's Flamey's turn. What other spells you got, Flame Man? Yeah. Let's cast Magic Missile.
Bug.
The Flame Skull shoots out some magical missiles, this time towards Boomcrash. And...
Hit me!
No, you're hidden. Can't hit you, you fool.
And I can catch it.
Wait, you can catch magic missiles?
No, she can't.
I can catch it.
She wants to think she can.
She can catch me with her face and suffer all damage of it.
I thought the whole point of magic missile was mostly, unless you literally counterspell against it, unblockable.
Yeah, that's the point.
Okay, it's only doing one at a time. I'm trying to find how many it was. It's like 3 or 4. Three. Got it. Cool. Okay. 15 force damage to Booncrash.
Okay.
It's then going to start zooming around here. It's got a case of those zoomies. Zumasu, it is your turn.
Where's it gonna walk up and stomp on it?
Okay. The warhorse moves up there. And
I think it only gets one. I didn't look up the stat for Warhorse, but I think it's literally just a d20 plus 1.
Yep, that is... Well, he's prone, so that's actually gonna hit for 12 bludgeoning damage.
Good job, Gregory! And now I'm gonna swing at him. Non-lethally, of course.
He is on the ground, so you probably need to get off your horse.
Okay, I'll get off my horse for the sake of advantage here.
Okay. You get off the horse, and you have advantage on your longsword attacks. That is gonna hit.
I'm just gonna, as I'm wailing, I'm just like, dude, we're gonna need, we're gonna ask you some questions after this.
We're gonna ask you some questions? Stab!
Alright, smiting. Okay, so that's, 8 plus 14. 22.
Okay, he's taking the damage.
Second attack?
There's a blast of lightning from his surging wound. That is also going to hit.
Non-lethal.
I mean, it's as non-lethal as you can make a blast of radiant lightning from the gods. I'm going to say it's going to be lethal if you choose to smite. Do you wish to?
I don't want to smite if it's going to kill him. Or if it knocks him out, can I literally just bring him back to life with one health?
You could do that.
I wanna... Okay, so yeah, I'm gonna let him go unconscious then. I'm gonna put manacles on him until, just like have a Mao, hold him, like, knife point and kill him back with one health.
Okay,
Does combat end if he's knocked out?
I mean, it doesn't necessarily end. Either way, you still need to do the smite.
Alright, I'll do the smite. That's the Radiant Smite?
I already did it for the other damage that you've done. I need the divine smite that you wanted to do. Okay. He is down. With a blast of radiant light, you say, "We need to ask you some questions," and then you stab him in the heart.
I do have Speak with Dead prepared, so we could just do that.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, if he's not dead, he probably...
He's dead, Jim. You stabbed him through the heart.
He doesn't have to answer us either way, just saying.
I feel like he's more likely to answer us if he's alive, though.
Yeah, I think so, too. He said something about Orcus.
Can
whatever
I just,
that means.
So, can I just keep him, can I bring him back to life and then have somebody else knock him out again?
I mean, he's still unconscious if you heal him, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm just clarifying. Can I heal him to not be dead, but to be still unconscious?
No, the healing brings him back.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so somebody would have to be over him to knock him out as soon as I heal him.
Are we moving out of turn order, or are we staying in turn order?
So as he goes down, the skeletons die. The flame skulls peter out and start to just drift off aimlessly into the woods. They are no longer compelled to attack.
Don't you have manacles, Zamasu?
Yeah, I do. I'm gonna take the manacles that I used on you last night and put it on this guy.
Tie him up next to a freaking tombstone. Or the pillar of the mausoleum.
Okay, well, time to the mausoleum. The dragon's body over. Mao first, although we should probably knock him out first. So Mao, get yourself in position. He's prone, so get advantage on the attack, and I'll just heal him for 1 hit point. You knock him in the head.
Okay, so hold your action until I move over there.
Yeah.
Okay.
He gets 1 lay on hands point to fake him up. She reacts to my healing him.
Okay. A turn cycle goes by, and you have him held up. Zumasu, it's your turn to heal him.
1 hit point.
He regains 1 hit point. Mao, you use your reaction?
Yep, immediately just hit him with the pommel of my scimitar.
Make an attack roll. You have advantage. That hits. He is knocked out.
Okay, so the issue is he's a necromancer slash cleric, so we need to set it up where if he is conscious, he can't escape and or cast spells, but still talk to us. How do we want to set this up?
First off, just saying, maybe we could find out more by opening up that mausoleum. He was trying to get inside when I showed up.
I guess that's fair, but then we need somebody watching him.
I raise my hand in my sword. I'm right here.
I guess that's fine. I was kind of hoping you'd be helping out with the traps or anything in there.
Also an option. I don't know, man.
What says you guys? Does anyone else mind babysitting?
I'll watch over him. God damn it, guys. I'll watch over and I'll punch him repeatedly if he wakes up.
Okay.
Get out of here.
Sprinkle some caltrops in front of it. Does anybody have any caltrops?
I'm not gonna do that. Just get it over with. I'm gonna punch him.
Okay. I'm gonna just heal myself real quick because I don't like being this low. He actually packs a wall up if he hits you.
Yeah. He's pretty well out. You've disarmed him, tossed his glaive aside and his shield. Well, his shield's probably on his arm. You've just tied it up with him.
Actually, while he's unconscious, I'm gonna rummage through his stuff. You guys go ahead.
Okay.
Yeah, can we separate the rest of his stuff so he's unarmed and any armor that we can remove without making him naked, you know?
It's hard to remove his armor while he's tied up. I'm going to say you can try and rummage through his stuff with an investigation check. The rest of you guys investigate the mausoleum. It appears to have script written upon it in Elven.
I do not speak Elven, technically.
I don't find anything of use, apparently.
Comprehend languages?
I think that comprehends the written word, so that is fine. You cast that upon yourself. Amon, you can't really reach any stuff of use. He has stuff on him, you just can't really get to it while he's tied up. So, Boom Crash, you look at the text written upon the front of this mausoleum. It seems to have the sigil of Ilore written, well, in relief on it, which is the symbol of the Senate. It also has the text, Morris Thane Mausoleum.
Huh.
Why is that name familiar?
Because you just heard it 2 days ago.
Oh, that is her name. I have it written down incorrectly.
What do you mean, her name?
The noblewoman. This is the family crypt where she was buried, so we can go and investigate her corpse.
We probably won't find the servant, though, or anything like that later. Just
no.
If we can find the corpse of the lady, though, we can always ask her if she was killed by what's-his-face, and if she has any proof.
Undead, yes. Probably what this thing was going to go do is destroy her if he's here. This seems really like a weird coincidence that we would find this shit out about Atorus, and now this is happening.
And I would also really, really love to know who the hell his master is.
He said Orcus, which is... Didn't we run into Orcus when we went through that demon portal thing?
You did not.
We did not run into Orcus, but my teacher in the Arcane College used to be a warlock under Orcus.
Can I do a religion? Is Orcus related to demons or anything?
You certainly can. Oh, is that your religion check?
Yeah,
he's fairly well known as a demon prince of the undead.
Okay, but he is demon related.
He is
That's
demon related, not devil.
And we do know that they're using.
Like, is Satan related to demons?
We know the Atorus, or at least the Vintners, have some sort of connection with demon.
Yeah.
No, devil. Mm-hmm. Demons are the other ones that we found underneath the mausoleum within Ilore, which might cause them to, you know, it's like two different factions trying to creep in on Ilore.
Wait, I thought the Vintners worked with demons because they
worked with devils.
Because devils can make better packs and they follow rules. Demons are chaotic, so they don't listen.
Oh, okay.
Otherwise, the front door to the mausoleum is not exactly something you can easily enter. There's no door knob. It's just a stuck stone slab.
Now I see why he was having those skeletons try to break it open.
Hmm. You can make an athletics check to try and pry it open if you have some sort of crowbar. I think you guys do.
I have a crowbar. Give me some help here, guys.
I've got mine, you got yours, we can try and get it out.
With an assist, you are able to finally, meaningfully crack open the mausoleum. As you do, the stone splits in half and falls forward towards you guys, and then splits in pieces on the ground. Inside, I think I have it here. Yeah, yes, I do. Neato. You guys open the mausoleum and look inside. There are several niches filled with the skeletal remains of creatures, humanoids, as well as a sarcophagus with a relief carved atop it on the far side of the room. Drifting down from the ceiling, however, is a strange orb-like creature with a central eye and a mouth with a gaping tongue. It has four tentacles, each tipped with an eye stalk. It lowers from the ceiling and goes,
I'm sorry.
And that's where we're going to pick it up next time. neat. Thanks, everybody, that came out to watch. We almost ran a little over time. Thank you all for coming out to watch. You can catch this stream every Sunday from 9 p.m. to midnight Eastern Time. Our sister stream is on Wednesdays from 7 p.m. To 10. And last but not least, I announced it on Tumblr and Twitter, but we do have a special event coming up. So we are doing a charity event for Extra Life for Tabletop Appreciation Weekend. That is in 2 weeks on the 23rd for when we normally would do this stream, but we're going to do it earlier, starting at around 7 p.m. It's going to be an extended session, and it's all for charity. All proceeds for my thing at Extra Life is going to the Hasbro Children's Hospital, and we're doing a special one-shot that will be hopefully in canon for this world, and it's going to be Spelljammer, so don't want to miss that. Come hang out and subscribe so you don't miss it. I will post links on Tumblr and Twitter to donate, especially donate on that day to increase the hype. And yeah, I think that's it for that announcement. So thanks all for watching again, and come see us next Sunday. Have a good night, everyone.
Bye.
Good night.